Hello everybody and welcome. I'm Brian DeMars for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be playing a standard league with Mono Black Zombies. And I'm going to be joined by my good friend from Ann Arbor, Andrew Ellenbogen.
Hello.
Who has been meticulously refining this deck for how long now?
A couple of weeks, I don't know, not a massively long time, but about a week and a half.
So one of the big draws to two zombies right now is it is days after the Pro Tour in Kyoto, and the Mono Red deck was all the rage. It wound up taking down the tournament. And Mono Black Zombies is a deck that is very well positioned in a post-Kyoto metagame.
Yes. Zombies beats the red deck that was all over the Pro Tour, and it's significantly favored against the Black-Green Constrictor deck that also performed well at the Pro Tour. Overall, it occupies a pretty similar place in the metagame to the Black-Green Constrictor deck, with the trade-off that Zombies has more polarized matchups. It's even better against Red, it's better in the heads-up, but it's worse against some of the more fringe decks.
That sounds pretty accurate. So, let's, I guess, go through and sort of talk about what is in the Zombie deck now that we know that it's good against Red and pretty well-positioned for the coming week. Like, the mana looks pretty stable for a mono black deck. You don't really have a ton of options, but 24 land strikes me as a lot of lands for sort of a aggro deck, but that is the staple. That is what people are doing right now.
Yes. The only notes I'll have to say on the mana base is this. Some people play 3 dead lands instead of 4. I prefer 4 with Kalidus in the main, because it means you're never stranded without a removal spell. If I didn't have Kalidus main, maybe I'd play 3, because drawing 2 can be awkward, but I think with the main of Kalidus, 4 is preferable. Some people also have the land that the Desert Exile Old Graveyards instead of the Westville Abbeys. I have found that the blue-white God Pharaoh's Gift deck is pretty much gone from the metagame, so that card's purpose has kind of been served. And Westville Abbey occasionally steals you games, generating tokens in late game or just flipping. I mean, I've certainly won 2 or 3 games off the card.
Sweet. So 24 lands, 2 Westville Abbeys, 4 Inferior Deadlands. Then as for the one drops, really the beef of this deck is these cheap 1 and 2 drop zombie cards. They're like A, very powerful, and B, very cheap and efficient, which makes them efficient. So we have 4 Crypt Breakers, which allows you to discard a card to create a 2/2 black zombie creature token, and it allows you to tap 3 untapped zombies to pay 1 life and draw a card, which is pretty insane. Just there's a lot of text on a one drop.
Yep, one of the best cards in the deck.
And then 4 Dread Wanderer, which is a 1-mana 2/1, so it's a Savannah Lion that is also, well, it's a Savannah Zombie Jackal, and it enters the battlefield tapped, but you can pay 3 mana to return it from your graveyard to the battlefield. Activate this ability only at any time you can cast a sorcery, and only if you have 1 or fewer cards in hand. So it's good on a 1-mana 2/1 is good on its own, but the ability to keep returning it to play late in the game is pretty huge. Just a threat that like won't die, keeps coming back. The other sort of awesome cheap zombie card, Relentless Dead, a 2-mana 2/2. Look at all the text on this card. It looks like a planeswalker. I'm really excited to get to play with this card more. I did some videos for a mono black deck in Modern. I was very impressed with Relentless Dead there, and I imagine it will be even more impressive in this video today. It's a 2/2, it has menace, it counts as a zombie. When it dies, you can pay a black if you do return it to your hand, and when it dies, you can pay X if you do return another zombie with converted mana cost X from your graveyard to the battlefield. So just a lot of recursion, a lot of very robust, hard to deal with threat there. Moving on through the cheap cards, we have 1 Gifted Aetherborn, which is sort of a concession to red decks.
Partially, it's also good against the black green decks I mentioned before, because it lets you trade for even very large constrictors or large creatures made large by Verdanous Gearhulk. Traditionally, zombies would play a Metallic Mimics in this spot. I just found that I didn't really want to draw Metallic Mimic almost against anything, so I basically just cut them, and I have this Gifted Aetherborn instead. Stocklist has like 2 Mimics, sometimes 3 or 4, but yeah, we have the Aetherborns and the main deck Cletuses instead.
So one of Aetherborn, we'll see what happens when we draw this fellow. He's kind of a weird guy. We also have 4 Grasp of Darkness. and two Fatal Pushes, which are pretty standard removal spells for this deck, but Andrew did make a little bit of an adjustment. The state you were telling me the stock was...
Yes, stock is 3 and 3. That's the list that most people playing at the Pro Tour. I think in the wake of the PT, killing Hazoret specifically and also killing Glorybringer post-board from the red deck is very important. And as a result, having 4 Grasp Darkness and 2 Fatal Push is superior to the 3-3 split. I don't think it's like, you know, it's probably a few percentage points better, but I think it is better.
Okay, so 6 removal, 4 Grasp, 2 Push. Onto the 3 drop slot, pretty elegant here, just 8 cards, 4 Lord of the Accursed, which is the uncommon Zombie Lord from Amonkhet, and 4 Diregraph Colossus, which is a card that's really been impressing me a lot since I've been playing with it. This card is super powerful in this deck.
Yes, it is. It's one of the best cards in the deck. It's kind of tricky to play. Sometimes you just want to slam it and hope it lives. Sometimes you want to wait to play it and another zombie in the same turn. Sometimes you want to wait till it's large enough to live through your opponent's removal spells and then play it safely and let it take over the game. There's a lot of different ways to play the card. I also think it's important to know with Colossus that... So if you have a Colossus in the graveyard and you have a Relentless that die and pay 3 to bring back the Colossus... The Colossus actually sees both itself and the Relentless Dead in the graveyard, and therefore will get both of them when counting how many counters it gets.
So it counts itself?
Yes.
That's pretty cool. I would not have thought that, but good Modo tip there. I assume that's come up on Modo.
yeah, I actually learned that from Andrea Mengucci's article on Channel Fireball, on this very website, that is.
Nice.
But yeah, it is. I then later used it to great effect on Modo.
Also, the art on this card, it's like a zombie made out of lots of tiny little zombies.
Yeah, it is pretty nice artwork that I can agree with.
It's pretty gross. But it's kind of cool, too. Lord of the Accursed, just sort of like a zombie lord value. Gives you guys menace.
Yes.
My favorite card to first pick in draft.
That is certainly true. I remember talking about this card before that, PT. But...
So, rounding out the rest of the main deck... I'm going to leave the Kalidas's for last because that's kind of a spicy one. But we have 3 Liliana's Mastery, which is another, it's like an anthem that makes 2 zombies when you play it. Very powerful, high-end threat card. And 4 Dark Salvation, which is just another super efficient removal spell in this deck. Also just a good value card. Worth noting, you don't have to have a creature in play that you're trying to kill to cast it, so you can just play it as, like, make a zombie, make 2 zombies, make 3 zombies, even if your opponent doesn't have a creature in play.
That's true, and it's one of the reasons you can sometimes leave the card in against more controlling decks, just to get value, and maybe pick off a creature if they happen to have one. The other note about Dark Salvation is that you can legally target your opponent with Dark Salvation, and the time this comes up is in the zombie mirror. If you target them, the creature gets -X, -X, where X is the number of zombies they control, is how the card is worded. So oftentimes if your opponent plays a Crypt Breaker on 1, you want to just slam Dark Salvation for 0 on it. Also, later in the game, if they just have more guys than you in general, you might want to cast it to kill a bigger guy for 1. So that's important to know.
That's a cool interaction there.
Yeah.
You probably don't want to pay more than... You don't want to pay any X then.
No, then they will get the zombies, so not recommended. Yeah.
So Dark Salvation, Liliana's Mastery, 2 of the more like high-end value token-y cards in the deck. Kind of interesting. Kind of a token deck in a lot of ways. A lot of token synergies in here. Crypt Breaker. And then also, last but not least, Kalidas, which, not a zombie, but has some zombie synergies nonetheless.
Yeah, and I just think Kalidas is just like one of the best cards you can have against the red deck game 1. Gets a little worse against the red deck games 2 and 3 when they board in Chandras and Glorybringers, but still a pretty effective card overall. If you get to 5-6, the red deck basically can't win. And it also does good work against the black-green deck, just getting value and, I don't know, comboing with all your kill spells.
Worth noting, it also like shuts off graveyard synergies as well.
Yeah. I mean, I think graveyard synergies are not incredibly prevalent in Standard right now, but certainly it comes up more than ever.
If you get this down against, like, you were saying that the God Pharaoh's gift decks are, like, less popular, but if you get this guy down before they have good targets, they kind of have to deal with this.
Well, they can just mill themselves.
Oh, I guess you're right. They can mill themselves.
But, yeah, it definitely comes occasionally. In the mirror, the Relentless Deads won't recur. Dread Wanderers won't recur. The Diregraph Colossus won't get too big. That's probably the match where it comes the most often, but it's not really a huge part of the card. Mostly just being two-twos when you kill things.
Yeah, seems pretty great. in these mid-range aggro matchups. So
yeah, it's definitely also important to note the fourth toughness on the Cletus means that, like, against three damage tweeters, keepers like Radiant Flames or Sweltering Suns, sometimes you'll want the card in post-board, even if the card does not seem obviously good against the controlling matchup.
Dodges, like, a Braid, too, and Incendiary Flow.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to kill.
Against the red deck, yeah. Okay, let's take a quick look at the sideboard. So, another Cletus. We were talking about where Cletus was great, so I assume we're going to be boarding it in the same spots. Why won't this work?
Yeah, so Cletus, yeah, for black, green, and mono red, basically. I don't think it's, like, incredibly important to have the third one. It could go, but I've liked it so far.
So we have a Cletus. We have another Fatal Push for, like, little creatures.
Primarily for snakes, because snakes are hard to kill with traditional removal. It's primarily for black, green, the third push. You might want it against mono red if they stay small, but usually they go big, so you end up not wanting it.
That's a good point. Probably not going to board this against mono red because they're going to board in bigger creatures.
Yes, precisely.
But decks that have good creatures that cost two that are defensive, like you played against a deck with a lot of, like, Gifted Aetherborns or something.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. We have some Liliana the Last Hopes. What are we going to use these for?
So because mono red decks usually go big, you actually counterintuitively don't want Liliana there, even though it would be excellent game one. You want it on the mirror on the play, since then it's more reasonable to kill Crypt Breaker and also just Planeswalker Sin there on the play, since you're more in a better spot. You also brought it against control decks like Blue Red, just as a non-creature threat, lifts the Wrath or Curse stuff. Those are the primary matches that comes in, honestly. I don't think Liliana is actually that great in Standard right now, but I am playing two.
Would you board this in against, like, Mardu if they had Veteran Motorists and Tool Crabs?
Yeah, probably I'd board it in against Mardu. I think Mardu's not particularly popular, but if I haven't faced it, yeah, I'd probably board it in.
Would you board it in just on the play or on the draw?
I might board it in on... Well, it depends on if I think the Mardu deck's going to transform. I think Mardu decks typically board out Tool Crabs and board in a bunch of, like, Wrath and stuff. So I suspect I would only want it if I thought they weren't going to transform, but if I thought they weren't going to transform, I'd want it on both.
Interesting. Okay. Worth noting, it has some space where maybe you would want it, maybe you wouldn't. This next suite is, like, a very important part of the sideboard, the discard spells. So 4 Transgress the Mind, 2 Doomfall. And the Doomfalls were something that we added later, because we just wanted more of this effect because it's so good. Andrew was actually telling me before, and I forgot to mention this, that a lot of the cards in the deck you don't ever touch when you're sideboarding. So you're not bored. You don't want to board out Crypt Breaker, Dread Wanderer, Relentless Dead, Diagraph Colossus. Those are, like, the core of the deck, and they stay in, like, basically no matter what.
Yeah, I pretty much never touch those 16 cards. I have in my life shaped like a single Dread Wanderer, but honestly, even then, I'm not even sure it's right. Those 16 are just great.
So the cards that are going to come out are, like, removal against decks where removal isn't good, or, like, some of these high-end cards, and possibly Lord of the Accursed when they're not good.
Yes.
So those are the cards we're working with. So this deck doesn't want to sideboard a ton because it's such a synergy deck. So when we are sideboarding, we want cards that are, like, very high impact and very important to the matchups. And one of those are these discard effects, because there are decks like Ramp and Control where it's really, they go over the top of us. They do things that really mess us up really bad with, like, Wrath effects. So, like, having a way to interact with these, you know, Wraths and powerful spells is going to be very important. So we actually added more Doomfalls to the deck to have more access to this ability, because it was one of the things we actually wanted to sideboard into.
Yeah, very much agreed. And I also think it's quite relevant that Doomfall has another mode. And the reason that's quite relevant is against Ramp, Ramp will empty its hand in a fairly timely manner. So having a Doomfall to exile that Worldbreaker and get your team through is pretty relevant. And a lot of the Ramp decks these days have few or no mana creatures. They won't have any fodder to exile whatsoever. So I think that's pretty nice. Also, there's this Black-Red Midrange deck that's, like, Cletus, Glorybringer, Goblin Darkdweller, Sweltering Suns, and Killspells. Seeing a lot of play on Modo right now. And against that deck, Doomfall's also great, because you really want to kill Cletus and you really want to kill Glorybringer, but you don't have too much removal in your deck post-board just because they have so few total targets. So I think Doomfall's second mode also is pretty nice for a variety of reasons.
That's why Doomfall over, like, say, Lay Bare the Heart or something.
Precisely, yes.
Moving on to the back end of the sideboard, we have two Never Recovers, which is just a very solid removal spell when you need to kill powerful creatures. You probably want to kill things like Kalidus, against those kind of grindy decks.
Yes, Kalidus and also Planeswalkers. Big Chandra out of control and Little Chandra out of Mono Red are both very important targets for Never Return. Black Green also sometimes borders in walkers that you might want to kill. Also, just kidding, like Furnace Gearhulk, our main deck is pretty much incapable of doing that. So, pretty much big creatures and walkers.
And the flip side's pretty, some good value too.
Yeah, I really like that against Ramp, if you board this card in, you can exile Kozilek's Return and exile Worldbreaker. That's come up for me several times. I know it doesn't seem like a major thing, it's like a 7-mana play, or like over 2 turns, but I've had it come up more than I expected.
And then last but not least, we have some vehicles. The one of Aethersphere Harvester. Aethersphere Harvester is just like a great blocker against aggressive decks because it gains life and it has huge toughness. It's also just kind of awkward to deal with for some of the control decks and stuff. It'll live through a sweeper. So it's kind of just like a robust threat. It's good against aggro. It's just kind of a good card.
Yes, it's particularly relevant that against Mono Red, it is 5 toughness, so it can block a Glorybringer and live. Because it's not a creature, it also is immune to Oncrop Crasher, essentially, because it like animates after they've already chosen what can't block. So it's, I think, basically, it's one of the few sideboard cards against Mono Red that's good whether they're transforming or not. And that's why I like it. And additionally, I randomly board against control decks as Wrath Insurance.
And last but not least, the Skyship, the Sky Sovereign Council flagship. So this is kind of our big haymaker creature in the sideboard. And it's very good against like the Zombie Mirror, very good against Black Green. It's just tough to, a lot of decks it's tough to answer because it's a vehicle. So it's immune to sorcery speed removal. It's also just going to come into play and destroy some or kill something, and then it's going to kill something every time it attacks.
Yes.
And also worth noting, it's huge and it flies.
Yeah, so you may note our zombie deck has literally no answers for Sky Sovereign. Most of the zombies Pro Tour have either zero answers or a singular murder for it, so it's basically unkillable. It destroyed Zyrecraft Colossus. It flies over the ground stalls that can create in the zombie matchup and the black-green matchup. Black-green also, by the way, the energy lists mostly have literally no answers to it in their library, so it's pretty hard for anyone to kill this card right now, just the way the rule spell is positioned. And yeah.
So that's the sideboard. That's the mono black deck we're going to be playing today. So hopefully it goes well and we win a bunch of matches and play some pretty sweet games. Have a lot of fun. So thanks for joining me, Andrew.
Anytime, Brian.
And we'll get down to business of playing some matches in just a minute here. One thing before we do, if you like the video, be sure to hit the like button. And if you see anything in the matches or you have any questions or comments about the games, be sure to drop those in the comment section below. I try to respond to those as much as I can. So if you drop those down there, I'll be sure to take a look at them and respond to you. And if you like the videos, also be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel for channelfireball.com. There's a lot of great content providers on there right now, a lot of great content. So it's a great way to stay up on the competition and see what, you know, a lot of the best players in the world are doing. You know, in standard or modern or whatever format you're following. So I'd like to thank you for tuning in. And in just a second, we will get to round one. Hello, everybody. Welcome to round one of Mono Black Zombies in Standard. Looks like we won the die roll. So we're going to go first. I don't know, Andrew. What do you think?
I think we should probably mulligan.
That's kind of my thought as well.
I mean, certainly this hand is a lot better than if it were two non-Dark Solation kill spells, because this card positively impacts the board while being a kill spell, but I still think our hands are mulligan.
Yeah, I think most hands of six are going to be better, so let's ship it. I was wrong. This particular hand of six is worse.
Yeah, clearly we should have snap kept.
Yeah, mistakes were made. All right, to 5. Oh my goodness.
Okay, to 4.
To 4 we go.
Stronger hand I've never seen.
Okay. So. opponent's playing. My expectations for winning this game very low. Yeah, go to 18. There it is.
Our opponent is playing the Soulscar Mage version of Mono Red, which is better in the mirror, typically. It's probably slightly better for us to use those instead of Village Messengers.
That little braid in for two.
Okay.
They go on to play the Relent instead.
I think so as well, because if we get it to... If we get the Diagraph Claw to the 4-4 at some point, then it's, like, out of range of everything.
Yeah.
So, might let us steal the game. I mean, it's tough, because we're just, like, so far behind because we mulled the 4.
Right.
this mold of 4 has been okay, but...
Oh, it's definitely an above-average mold of 4.
Yeah.
Ooh. A nice trick is that you can grasp as your Kenra, and if you do, it doesn't prevent anything from blocking.
Because it goes on last known information,
yeah.
So it'd be a negative two, yeah, power guy, yeah.
So
I think we just gotta play as Colossus, right?
Yeah, it's so unfortunate. I mean, if he kills it, we cannot win, but that's where we're at now.
Inversely, if we don't play it, we cannot win.
Well... Yes. Often against Mono Red, I like to slow roll my Colossus, but with this few resources, we probably cannot wait any longer.
Bowman.
Interesting. So it looks like our opponent might have a Village Messenger Soulscar Mage split.
Just all the one drops, huh? Okay.
I mean, maybe he has more than four of the bad one drops, but that would be surprising.
Here they all come.
So we probably do not have the luxury of playing around Shock here.
Do you want to block the two power guy? He's pretty far away from flashing it back.
Yeah, okay.
Just prevents the damage. She's got the Ranap Ruins with two lands in play.
No, I think you're right.
Yeah. Take three? Seven?
Okay, that's probably a good sign for us.
Well, the other problem is that we're just so far away from, like, ever actually attacking. It's kind of weird.
Hold on. So...
The problem is we gotta take a bunch of damage to do this.
Well, that's true, but we'll be at 5 with 4 blockers. He's an empty hand. I mean, we could not do it. We could only play one guy. That isn't out of the question.
How do you feel about maybe playing Crypt Breaker?
Well,
I guess we... It's just like, I don't know if we have enough time to flip the script here. Maybe we do just need to go to 5.
No, I think you might actually be right if we... Okay, so we only play one guy. He still probably doesn't have good attacks. Unless he draws, like, on Cop Crasher, but we're probably beyond playing around such things. I think I'm okay casting only one creature. If that's true, you think it should be Crypt Breaker?
Well, Crypt Breaker, we don't take damage.
Yeah, and then if we draw a Swamp, the Relentless Dead will be a good play then. I think I'm okay with that, because then we only take one damage and we cast it next turn, even if we don't draw a Swamp. Like, we're guaranteed to save ourselves one life. Also,
what happens if our opponent draws something that makes something not blocked? We just die?
It's very bad for us. So, I mean, he'll make this not block. He'll attack with his team. We'll block this on the On-Crop Crasher. And we'll block one of our other creatures on this 2-1, and we'll take 3 down to... 4 life.
I almost think we just... Actually, I think we kind of just have to play both things.
I just think we should accept that we can't beat him drawing a Homecraft Crasher and play one thing. Like, I think it's incredibly ambitious to try to beat that.
So, yeah, I think the Crypt Breaker is the way to go. Also, it's worth noting that the village messengers gain menace when they flip, and this way we'll also have the ability to... We'll take one less damage to get it into play, but, like, we won't let those messengers flip next turn.
Yes, we're guaranteeing the messenger will flip even if we do draw land. Okay. Now, do you want to draw a card at our opponent's end of turn?
If we draw a swamp, it's like...
it's really good.
Yeah.
I kind of think we should.
I think we should, too.
I mean, it's tough when our electrical is this low, but... Okay, that was not a very good draw.
Okay, well, that was a good draw.
Cool.
So we can play Relentless Dead.
I think we should, right?
Yeah. And then I'm pretty sure we need to make some attacks here.
I agree, but I'm not sure what they are.
So the opponent has five attackers. We have five blockers.
Yeah. I mean, I think we probably can't send more than one creature, would be my guess. So I guess I'm proposing attacking for, like, two with a Relentless Dead.
Peter has Menace.
Yeah, so he probably doesn't have good blocks.
Six, five. We're not technically dead to a Crasher this turn.
Yes.
Are we dead to a Crasher if we attack?
I might be. So we attack, he plays Crasher, prevents from blocking the alphas, you block three guys, we take... So no, we're not dead to it, but it's bad for us. We'll take...
We have lethal on the swing back if we have a land for this mastery. Three...
I just think that...
I think we should attack.
I'm not sure that, like... It's not that I think that we're likely to beat it on Crypt Crasher with this line. It's just that, like, I think we have to do something sometime, or eventually we'll die to, like...
Yeah, I agree.
Like, he has Romcop Runes out, he has the Kenra on the yard. He's got a lot of inevitability here.
I agree. Just trying to weigh if it's better to do it this turn or do it next turn.
Yeah.
Because it's only 2 points here, and if you're... You know, it's the kind of thing where we're potentially risking a lot for 2 points of damage, but the 2 points of damage might actually matter a lot, and that's sort of the tension trying to sift out.
Yeah, it's definitely a tough play. I'm not, like, 100% certain the attack is right. But I do think that if we try to consider Crasher, we'll just end up never doing anything. Because, like, are we going to consider it next turn? Like, how long are we going to consider it for? Okay, so on his end step, I definitely think we should draw a card. Right?
Yep.
Ooh. Now we could pay one life and discard mastery to make a 2/2, but I think that's likely bad.
That would put us to 4. Opponent, worth noting, opponent cannot ramp up ruins us this turn.
True.
But those guys are going to flip.
I also think they might have a burn spell in their hand, because what would they, like, not play here?
There's some stuff they might not play, because, like, they want to flip those messengers.
Oh, you think if they just drew, like, a random one drop, they'd probably just pass, perhaps?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, I think I want to untap. Do you want to take one?
No. Let's untap.
Okay. So, now that we have this Kalidus, I think the situation's a little bit different, because if Kalidus attacks, I think the game ends.
Possibly true.
So I think I just want to attack Cleats and leave everyone home, because now I just want to not lose.
I agree. Just try and survive this turn.
Yes. If we survive this turn, I think it is... Well, if we survive and Kalita survives, I think it's very likely that we win.
We probably should have made a guy, actually.
I'm unsure about that. It depends on the odds you think that our opponent drew a burn spell this turn. If he drew a burn spell, then you're putting us dead to him drawing any other burn spell or any land, because he could EOT burn a... Well,
we need 7 blockers to block everything down. We have... Well, we do have 7 blockers, so...
Right, that was my count.
Yeah. And if they draw a Crasher, we might still live.
We won't die.
This is so close.
And then after we don't die to the Crasher, we'll untap Sakazombie to Cleats and gain 5 life. So, like...
We did it!
Oh my god. The classic...
On the Moldaphor. Wow. Off to a good start.
Oh man. Zombies is so great. Okay. So, typically, the mono red deck is going to go pretty big post-board.
Agree.
So, I typically like to assume that they're doing that, and I like to board in, like, I like to not board in the Liana, because they usually cut a lot of their one toughest guys.
Okay.
I like to board in Kalidus, Never Returns for Chandra and Glorybringer, and the Aether Sphere Harvester.
Okay.
So, as far as cuts, I think that Liana's Mastery is a little slow. It's a fine card, but it's a little slow.
Okay.
So I usually like go down on those.
I like that.
And then I go down, cut 2 Lord of the Accursed. He's fine this matchup, but he's just probably the worst guy.
A lot of braids and stuff floating around that are going to kill him.
Trades down on mana most of the time.
Yeah.
He rarely takes over the game like a Diagraph Colossus does, and he's not really cheap enough to print the early beats like these guys are.
Yeah. Diagraph Colossus really bailed us out that game.
I mean... It's one of the best cards in the deck.
Yeah.
So I think this is about where we want to be. I'm not exactly sure if like you want like precisely 2 Fatal Push or 3 or 1. It's like somewhere in that range. You want like some, but not a massive number. But this looks kind of reasonable to me.
Is it maybe we're on the draw? Maybe we do want 1 more Fatal Push.
Yeah. So if we want another push, maybe cut another Lord. Probably, I guess.
That leaves us 21 creatures.
That's true, although this and this both make creatures.
That's fair. Yeah, let's run it like this. This looks pretty good.
I think this matchup specifically, you often cast Dark Salvation on turn 3 to kill a 1-1, like a Biomat Courier or something.
Sure.
This hand looks pretty good to me.
Yeah. Everything but the 1-drop, right?
Yeah, pretty much. And we only have 8, so we can't realistically expect to always have a 1-drop. Well, I guess we have Fatal Push too, but still.
Try a little Fatal Push here. There we go.
Okay.
If he attacks, do you want to trade here?
Good question. I'm not sure.
I kind of do. I feel like we have enough late game type stuff going on.
Yeah.
I want to do it.
I think you're right. I dislike that makes it harder to Dark Salvation on turn 3 to kill his guy, but it's probably still correct.
Salvation that.
Okay, Relentless Dead.
Yep.
I kind of want to take this.
Yeah, me too. Turn on those Dark Salvations in our hand. A little bit harder?
Yes. It's a lot of salvation. Okay. I think we probably want to cast a salvation for 1 on the Gorger.
Sure.
I mean, we unfortunately
can't... Do you want to attack first with the Relentless? Oh, it is Menace.
Well,
I was thinking he might block, and then he could get carries up, but I just realized our guy has Menace, so he doesn't have the option. He or she doesn't have the option to block.
We also might want to double block Carry Zev.
That's also true.
So I think this is the right play?
Yeah, let's do it. Maybe we should just get in for two.
Oh, sorry.
I kind of think... I think it's close. I don't really want a double block because I...
Well, it's not like we really get blown out. If he has a kill spell, he just kills a guy that he would be killing anyway.
Yeah, that's fair.
Like, right. And I kind of want him to kill one of these guys because if he does do that, then Diagraph Colossus will be 4-4, so out of range of a lot of his stuff.
Sure.
I mean, it's not, like, a massive game, but I think it's probably right. Or?
Just get it? Oh, probably has another one, then.
That is probably what that means, but
that's still fine.
I'm still very happy with that exchange.
Yeah, 2 mana, turn your 2-drop, good creature into shock. We would have killed it later, anyway.
Okay, so now we have some options. We could Dark Salvation this, but if he kills our zombies in response, yeah.
So we're winning too much right now.
I think I agree. So you just want to like push his guy and attack for 4?
Push his guy, attack for 4, play another Relentless Dead?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm totally into that. Seems great. So this is a... We get more... This is a kind of an interesting play for those of you watching at home, where we had two options. We could Dark Salvation and potentially kill his creature, which is a more mana-efficient play for us. If it goes through, but the problem with that play was if our opponent has a shock, they break up our thing, and then it's a much worse play. And because we're winning by a fair margin, we want to make the safer play. We don't want to give our opponent the chance to have a shock and, you know, get back into the game.
Yeah, definitely agreed. If we were in a worse spot, we might take that more aggressive line, but since we're in such a winning spot, there's no reason to take the risk.
Right. See, now that our opponent is tapped out, we can do the play we wanted to make last turn. Just keep getting value. Kill this sandy, little sand creature. Our opponent's tapped out now. They can't do anything about it.
Yep, definitely get seems right.
4. Keep our opponent on the back foot, just keep these beats going. We have another Dark Salvation, we have a Diagraph Colossus that we're just building up.
It's a 4-4 right now, so it's getting to pretty big sizes.
Yeah, totally. That doesn't even do anything.
It's turned off right now. We also could Dark Salvation it dead and make 2 zombies.
I feel like our opponent might like have another one or whatever. It can't block, so let's just hit our opponent for 6 and play our Diagraph Colossus.
Yeah,
and then next turn we'll have more options.
Okay, yeah, I'm in for that.
Like, we're not going to get 10.
No, I think you're right. I think the other thing is we might want to save our Dark Salvation here for a Glorybringer. Although, I suppose if he has that, then he kills the Colossus anyway.
Yeah. Like, the Hazoroth's not doing any... Like, it can't really attack.
Yeah.
One's too far behind. It can attack.
Yeah, you say that, Brian, but here comes Hazoroth.
Like, whatever.
Oh, wow.
Alright, we got paid off just slightly. Just slightly did we get paid off for waiting.
Okay, so I think we should cast Dark Salvation for 2 on the Hazoroth. We could do it for only 1 and play Crypt Breaker and leave up Relentless Dead, but...
Crypt Breaker makes 2 zombies.
That is true. So I guess we... so maybe that's just... better. It's tough because I don't really know how we lose from here.
Yeah, let's just Dark Salvation for 2.
Yeah, I don't know if this is right or wrong, but I also think it's very irrelevant at this point.
Yeah, I mean the best card our opponent can draw is like Glorybringer.
And I think that's unlikely to be good enough.
And I think that they still lose if they draw that. Okay, we won.
Classic winning on a mold of four.
Very nicely done. Very nicely done. Hello, everybody. Welcome to round two with Mono Black Zombies and Standard. We won round one on a pretty epic mulligan to four, so hopefully we can replicate some of that good luck here. Looks like we're on the play or the draw?
We are on the play. I think with one land, we kind of have to mulligan.
Yeah, I'm with you. This is kind of a mana-intensive hand anyway, so we're going to mulligan to six.
We're flawlessly going to execute our strategy of mulling to four and winning once again.
I like it. Well, this hand seems much better, so let's keep it.
Darn, the mold of four dream is dead. I agree.
You know what, let's just keep it at the one time. One time was good enough.
That's probably a top, is my guess. It's close.
Yeah, let's stop it.
Like, I think if we didn't have the Liliana's Mastery, we might well bottom. But given that we do, I think we're supposed to top.
That's fair. So what do you think, Cryptbreaker or Dread Wanderer on one here?
Good question. So, if we wanted to discard a card to the Cryptbreaker, we should play the Cryptbreaker on one. And we might want to do that because we could just discard the Dread Wanderer and then, like, essentially turn it into a 2/2.
No, I think we want to discard probably something else.
Or discard maybe.
We know we're not going to get another one drop to draw a card, but this way we can possibly turn on drawing cards of Cryptbreaker on turn three.
Well, the Dread Wanderer enters the battlefield tapped. So that won't be on regardless.
Oh.
There's, like, no way to guarantee that, though none of our lines do. I still
maybe
think
we play turn one Dread Wanderer then.
You think we're not interested in turning a card into a zombie right now? That's plausible.
I think we probably just want to play Dread Wanderer, attack with it, play Cryptbreaker, and there's a very good chance we just want a Fatal Push next turn.
Yeah. No, I'm okay with that. I mean, I think the one extra damage is marginal, but yeah. there's probably very little upside to the other play. Since I think you're right, given that we know our top card is a land that we want, there's no obvious card we want to turn into a 2/2. I mean, yeah, discarding a Dread Wanderer is a pretty marginal upgrade.
I also just think this Dread Wanderer is going to deal 4 points of damage, which is nice.
Yeah. Looks like we're probably up against Black Mane Constrictor here.
Yeah. Let's attack first. Maybe they want to push it.
Yeah, I mean, that could be a thing that happens. I hope it's a thing that happens. Okay.
Play the Cryptbreaker. And we have the push up if they have a snake or whatever.
Yeah. I think the two main ways to lose this matchup are to Snake game one and Yamini's Expertise games two and three. So definitely leaving a push for Snake makes sense. Okay.
Not a ton of action, but our opponent's still going to have to play something that dies to this push, which is nice. And I guess we are kind of close to playing this Mastery. We kind of just need to draw live next turn.
Yeah, agreed.
Perfect. Let's push that.
Agreed.
Push it real good.
Oh, wait a minute. Actually, is there a reason not to untap?
No, do it now.
So, the only 4-drop in our deck is Kalidus, right?
Yeah.
If we draw Kalidus, I would rather not have pushed it. Because I'd want the push in my hand to come up with the Kalidus. So, like, why push it now? What draw makes that correct?
Can't play the Kalidus next turn and push.
But I would want to not have pushed it if I draw Kalidus, right? Or you think that's not true? You think if we drew Kalidus next turn, we'd want to
I think we're just it. Happy with every... Like, the problem is, we don't push it. Okay, so we don't push it. We draw Kalidus, which is, like, a 2-outer in our entire deck. And we don't push it. We played the Kalidus so we could try and push it with Kalidus in play. What are the odds that we get to untap and Kalidus just doesn't bite it to, like, a grasp or, like, any removal spell of some sort?
I mean, not that high. Our opponent has four grasps. That's certainly true. Their pushes won't kill it, and those are their two kill spells that are typically in black-green lists. But if we draw anything that isn't Cletus, we can still push it. It's not like we lost anything. The mana is not relevant, since every other card in our deck costs, you know, like either more than four or less than four. So we still get to push it. We don't lose anything. The only scenario that matters is the Cletus scenario.
I feel like we wanted to push it even if we draw the Cletus. Just because I don't want to, like, get... I don't want our opponent to, like, grasp our Cletus and then, like, attack and get...
Yeah, you don't want them to get through with the Grim Flare. Yeah, okay, that's fair.
Yeah. I just want this dead, like, no matter what.
I just thought it was worth talking about because it's all about the Cletus here. Because anything else, it's irrelevant.
Yeah.
Okay. Want this dead. It's a decent drop.
That was another reason not to push it, to wait on the push.
Well,
now we have mana to get back the Crypt Breaker and buy back Relentless Dead if they kill it somehow.
I don't think our opponent would be expending a removal spell on our Relentless Dead either way, even if we only have one mana up here.
That's probably fair. Just untap, kill Relentless Dead. Like,
yeah, like,
gotcha, get back two guys.
I suppose they could take that line, but it would be very surprising to me.
Well, we had it covered, so it's all good. Kill that tracker and get in there.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of unfortunate. I feel like we're kind of getting ground out here, but it's where we're at.
I think that this mastery is going to, like, do a lot of work.
It probably is, I agree.
It better. It better, or we're going to be in trouble.
Yeah. I mean, I think in general, mastery is a pretty good card in this matchup.
Opponents has three types?
Yeah, three types.
That's nice. Moto reminds us. Tells us right there, three types.
Yep.
Does Moto tell us how many types we have?
It tells you, I think, if you have a Delirium card in your deck.
Ah.
So it does not currently tell us.
Oh, no.
Well, if we draw Mastery, we can still Alpha. Draw Land for Mastery, that is. Okay.
Oh, look at that. All right.
And I think we likely want to
Hold
do
on. That. Cool. Yeah, okay. We can't infer runes at instant speed, right?
No.
Okay. Got some zombies and some zombie attacks.
Yeah. Now I think our position is pretty good.
Seen better. Seen worse. I like this.
I'm surprised our opponent wanted to do that, honestly. I wonder what that means about their hand.
Probably bad. Or maybe they don't have Delirium, so we can't get Ishkenad here.
Yeah.
Cletus is probably the worst card for us.
I mean, I guess if they have Cletus Killspell, that would be very bad. Oh, I sense weakness.
Yeah, well, they still have 4 mana, so it could be Cletus.
Well, true, but Cletus without a Killspell we could definitely beat, I think. Mindrak Demon.
Oh, wow.
That's not a card
Looks you
see
like
a lot of.
It's like never to return also, potentially.
Oh, that's a good point. So, we could sack Ifnir Deadlands on the Demon, attack with our entire team. They would have the chump block. If we do that, we are going to let our Dread Wanderer get returned. But maybe that's fine. Because the other line would be to recur Dread Wanderer and just attack our opponent for 3 damage with the Menace Relentless Dead.
It also puts our opponent 2-3.
Yeah, so if they're at 3, let's see, they return that. That's a pretty bad spot for them. I think I like the Sack Deadlands line better.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I think it's pretty hard for them to get out of that. They could traverse and cast Ishkenah, but if they're doing that, then they're not returning the Dread Wanderer, so we won't be punished for taking this line.
Still got the Swamp, which we're playing, so that if Relentless Dead were to somehow die, we can return it to our hand.
Yep.
I think it's kind of Ishkenah, Wrath, or Bust here. Oh, well, Ishkenah.
sometimes. Sometimes they don't have a main deck Ishna. Okay, well, this guy does. I think this guy might be playing, like, a really old-school grindy Delirium list.
Yeah, it looks like it. I see a lot of card advantage cards.
Yeah. That probably means we want to board differently.
Okay. That I think we can afford to hold.
So, we definitely want to attack with the Relentless Dead, because our opponent killing it is actively good for us.
Yeah.
I think we might want to attack with only the Relentless Dead.
I agree.
Like, I assume our opponent has to kill this, but, like, man, if they do, it's so bad for them.
They probably shouldn't. They should probably just block with two spiders.
Oh, I guess that only troublebox away one of them? Yeah, maybe that is what they should do. Historically, Zombies has been good against decks with Ishkanah in them because Zombies can often just continue to do, like, zombie things through the Ishkanah.
Yeah. Then we can bring back our Dread.
Right.
If that guy dies, we just want to bring back Crypt Breaker anyway, so we can hold this swamp for now.
Yeah, I think it's right to hold it. It's kind of close. If we draw an If Near Deadlands later, we might want to have retroactively had it in play, but we also might want to discard it to a Crypt Breaker. So it's...
I think them not knowing what's in our hand is,
yeah,
some value too.
That's true.
Not a ton of value, because they're kind of just up against it, but... So close. We might lose this game.
We might.
We needed to draw Live last turn.
I agree that if we'd drawn Live last turn, it would have been a lot better for us. They are going to exile the Crypt Breaker to prevent us from letting it back.
Wise.
Which is fair.
Wise. Value?
Okay. Well... Holding land definitely worked out there.
Oops. Oops. Alright, we need a live one here.
I agree. That's decent. So I don't think we want to hold this land anymore, because there's no reason to do so. And we probably want to cast the Dryraft Colossus, because what else are we going to do with our time?
Sure. Still attack with the Relentless Dead.
Well,
you know what? We should have held that.
Oh, so we can attack in... Oh, I'm sorry. That was right.
Yeah.
I apologize.
We don't have anything to get back, but like now if our opponent kills it, they know that we'll replay it and get a zombie.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. That was just a mistake. Definitely, I should have played this... not attack with Relentless Dead first.
Yeah, we're still going to attack with Relentless Dead, though.
Yes.
Gotta grind these little blockers off.
We also could attack with the Dread Wanderer, because it's recursive, but I think that's bad.
The Dread Wanderer just blocks, gets blocked by Ishkanah and dies.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it doesn't make sense this turn. It prevents the Ishkanah from blocking the Relentless Dead would be the point, but this turn that's irrelevant.
Black now to return the lot instead to our hand. I think we should just replay it.
Yeah,
since
I agree.
If there's a removal spell involved, now it might kill the dead, but like it would have just killed the Colossus anyway.
Yeah, I'm not
it
even
still will probably kill the Colossus, so it doesn't matter.
Exactly. Like I'm not sure even which one I want our opponent to kill, so leaving up the extra mana is totally fine. I mean not leaving it mana, the one's dead.
Yeah.
Our opponent is now Hellbent. They have the ability to animate one Hissing Quagmire to block. So if we kill the Grimflayer and Alpha, what happens is they will block one of their guys on each of our creatures. Wait, they'll die because we have the Relentless Dead, right? Oh, they're at 5 life now.
Like, so opponent has, let's assume the Grim Flayer's dead, so opponent has two Hissing Quagmires or one?
They only can animate one.
They can animate one Quagmire. So they have Zombie, two Spiders, Ishkanah, Quagmire. It's five blockers, and we have three, four, five, six attackers, and one of them has Menace.
So they just
won't block the Relentless Dead.
Yes. They'll
block everything else.
So they will eat Diagraph Colossus, trade their Zombie for Dread Wanderer, and trade the Hissing Quagmire for Zombie, and chump off two Spiders. That seems good for us.
So I think the actual attack is that we want to kill the Grim Flayer, attack with everything but Diagraph Colossus. Because that's so... the one. I don't care about the other stuff dying. The only thing I care about dying is Diagraph Colossus, because it's the one that generates two twos.
I understand your point, but hold on a moment. If we actually make the alpha play,
yeah,
right? So our opponent takes three down to two. We will lose Diagraph Colossus. They will lose... We lose Diagraph Colossus and a Zombie. They will lose everything except Ishkanah.
Except Ishkanah.
And then next turn, we will have Zombie, Zombie, Relentless Dead, Dren Wander against opponent two life. I want to alpha strike. Like, I don't think... I understand what you're saying. You're trying to play for the long haul, but, like, I think the long haul is over. Let's end the game.
All right, let's do it.
Yeah, in the other line, they get to keep an additional creature, and they get to double up on our zombies and kill it. So we actually do lose significantly.
Yeah, you're right. I wasn't thinking about that part. That opens up one more blocker, so they can double block. Also, hopefully the game just ends here. I think the only way the game doesn't end here is if our opponent draws Kalidas.
Maybe another Ishkanah, or another way to find Ishkanah.
Yeah.
They definitely don't have a lot of outs.
So the Quagmire gets fired up. They're going to block down everything except the Relentless Dead.
And we bring back the Dread Wanderer post combat.
I like it. Cletus isn't even good enough here. It is, because they can fire up the second fragment.
Yeah, I think it just is, but.
Cool. All right. So they're really grindy black-green.
Yeah, that's kind of a weird matchup. I'm not exactly sure how we want to sideboard. My guess is that Sky Sovereign is good, because our opponent probably has very few answers to it, and it attacks into an Ishkanah pretty well.
It's true.
We might want Transgress the Mind. They're probably boarding in Yemeni's expertise, so we might want Transgress to take that.
Sure.
Nothing else really jumps out at me. Like,
I feel like this is probably a bad matchup for Kalatas, right? Or do you think it's a good matchup for Kalatas?
It's tough. I like.
I mean, they're going to have card grasps.
Against traditional black green, but against this deck, it's like a lot bigger, a lot less aggressive. They probably have more removal than the little version. It's probably not at its best. Liliana's Mastery is good in this matchup, but I'm wary of having too many 5-drops, so I typically shave one when I board in the boat, as it were.
Okay.
I think Fatal Push kills Grim Flayer.
And that's about it.
Yeah.
I did it twice, though, and it was good.
True. I mean, do you think it's better or worse than Grasp?
I think Grasp is probably worse.
I think I agree. I mean, that's like almost sacrilege against the normal black green deck. Against this deck, I think it makes sense. I also think it's possible that Never Return might be good.
So they just have like
Well, because he's like demon, which grass doesn't kill. Basically, I'm wondering if grass would just be never returns.
Yeah, let's do that. I like that. You could theoretically also like knock them off delirium.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that is nice. I didn't.
How do you feel about like Doomfall?
I suspect it, given they have Ishkanah, we don't want that. I just also don't want to have like too much discard.
And Liliana?
Probably not. I think we probably want to shave one Lord of the Accursed. It's just like the worst creature and it's bad against Yemeni's expertise.
Yeah. Oh, let's get this Gifted Aetherborn out of the deck, too.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. So you want to leave the Lord?
Well, let me think. Now can I have any card I want out of the sideboard?
I'm almost wondering if we want Kalidus because it lives through expertise. But that would be crazy.
One Kalidus can't hurt. Let's try one Kalidus.
It's legendary, so it's missing returns. It could be right. Okay.
Is four transgress too many? Maybe we want three transgress and we can get like another push in there?
I think we probably want four. I'm not sure. It's close.
Alright.
I've never played against like old school delirium style Black Green before. Fair. So like a lot of my knowledge is against the traditional version, and I'm not entirely sure how this match is gonna play out.
I think this game's pretty good. I mean, it's not great, but like I like where it's at so far.
I agree. Ideally our opponent plays a Grim Flayer on two so we can Dark Salvation it.
Mm-hmm. After taking Yahini's expertise.
Yes.
Transgress or Kalatas.
You understand the plan.
Yeah. I get it. Oh, we're on the draw, too? That's so lucky.
If we do see a lot of Kalidus from our opponent, then maybe we'll want to board some grass back in. But I think between Dark Salvation, Never Return, like, we'll probably have enough answers. And Transgress.
Yeah. Opponent plays a creature land, a Hissing Quagmire.
Yeah, our opponent did a lot of hissing last game, but they still ended up in a pretty bad Quagmire.
What's our opponent in the tank about? Are they casting a pact?
I can only assume they're about to gut shot our face.
Yeah.
See, that gets someone closer to delirium.
They banned Probe in Standard, right?
I assume so.
Okay. Alright, I like picking up another removal spell here.
Yeah. I mean, I also think that this is the sort of game where the flashback could be very relevant.
Yeah.
Wow.
Alright, that's kind of slow.
This guy is serious about his delirium.
So let's attack first. And then post-combat we'll transgress.
Yep, I agree. I doubt there's any card we'd possibly see that would cause not transgress. Oh, he's killing it? I like that.
I don't love it. Ooh, they brought in answers to the boat.
Wow, that's surprising. I actually often don't see that. I think we should probably take Never Return, though.
Yeah.
Just as a 2-for-1, basically.
Yeah. Torment of Hellfire?
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
It's very weird.
So, if we slam that, he will grasp it. But I'm not sure we're getting around that.
Takes up his turn next turn.
I mean, we could just Dark Salvation make a 2-2. I understand that's unimpressive. I guess maybe we just want to wait to get castles on 5 and make 2-2-2s.
Yeah, let's just get this Colossus out of our hand.
Okay. I mean, the other thing I like about this line, and the reason I definitely want to play something rather than nothing here, is that I want to eventually turn the Dread Wanderer on.
Right. I'm with you there. It also is going to take our opponent's turn up here. What did they do?
He drew another Never Return. He cast Never on it. Right. Nope. Okay. Well, this Kalidus is not great here, because he will just grasp it. But...
let's just play grasp for one.
Yeah, I think that's the play.
Or salvation for one, I'm sorry.
It's tough, but I think this is right. Obviously, if we can bait out the grasp, that's great. But yeah. I think it's more likely that he won't grasp, and we'll just start hitting the two. That doesn't necessarily mean it's wrong. Is this return flashback?
Yeah, from the Dread Wanderer, I'm sure.
Yeah. Lord of the Accursed. I'm kind of tempted to cast that and try to bait out the
grasp. I'm with you there, for sure. We can get him for three.
Yeah. The other line, of course, being just Dark Salvationing for one and killing his guy, but I don't think his guy is incredibly important, and I kind of want to wait till five to cast this.
No, I'm totally with you. How many types does our opponent have, by the way?
I think they're Delirious. No, wait, no. Enchantment, Instant, Sorcery. So they have... three types? So now they're Delirious. Okay.
All right, the grasp.
That's cool. I like where this is going.
Blue draw.
So, do you want to transgress our opponent to try to clear the way for the Kalidus even more? They only have one unknown card. They have Appetite for the Natural and Unknown. But that Unknown could easily be a rule spell.
The problem is it has to be, like, a very specific...
oh, because we can't even take Grasp, you're saying. So it's only, it only matters if it's, like, never return.
Yeah, I think another... we should just play the Kalidus.
Yeah, that seems reasonable. Okay, so let's attack for two first.
See if they grasp it.
I mean, you never know.
They could push it real good.
Okay, they didn't do any of those things.
I hope this Kalidus lives.
Well, they didn't grasp it. Step one.
Yeah. Let's pop up that Kalidus, make him real big on the screen. Very nice. You can do the counter thing against the speed too, huh?
Yep. So that definitely opens up some lines. If we make our Kalidus 5/6, obviously it will mean that no grafts can get kill it.
I don't want to do that.
I mean, I'm not saying like we're going to untap and like immediately do it. I'm just saying if at some point we choose to do that.
For sure.
What is this? A Gearhulk? Ishkanov? Nissa.
Oh, wow.
I mean, we do have this Never Return, so...
this goes to six.
Yeah, so what I'm wondering is this. We could kill the Nissa with Never Return, straight up. We could kill the land to make a 2/2, and then attack Nissa with both our guys. But I think I'd rather just kill Nissa. Like, I just basically think that Nissa will generate more than a 2/2's worth of value if it lives. Is the claim I'm making. Because he'll...
what if we, we could, what if we played, like, Colossus, and then Dark Salvation, the token, and hit it? That only puts it to one, though.
Yeah, and we also wouldn't get a zombie because this guy's a token. So I think I like that less than just... I just want to never turn this and be done with it, honestly. Like, I don't know why we're messing around.
Yeah, alright, I like that. I like that. It also gets it in the graveyard, which is
Yes.
Did we have the Dark Salvation to deal with, like, a problematic threat or whatever? So let's bash with the just the Kalathas, I think.
I agree, because I think we want the zombie in play because of the Dark Salvation.
And, like, Mastery, you're drawing another...
Yeah, I mean, basically we're just saying our token is more valuable than his token.
Right. Or it does have that Quagmire back to potentially block, which is... We can kill this, though, which is nice.
Well, we can't if he leaves mana up.
Why not?
Because Kalidus isn't a zombie. Mm,
we draw a land and kill.
Yes. You want to take two?
Yeah, for sure.
To leave that up, that option open.
Because we can just attack with Kalidus if we want.
Yes. Okay. I think we do this.
You want to attack with Kalidus?
Oh.
Opponent has one, two cards?
So, if our opponent has a cure removal spell in response, then attacking with Kalidus first is correct, because that might spend the kill spell on Kalidus, then we still get to kill the tracker.
Right.
Okay. I'm in for that.
Well, the other thing to consider is, if our opponent blocks, are we sacrificing the zombie?
Oh, wait. If our opponent actually has Grasp, we're going to attack, they're going to block. And if we Dark Salvation, they'll blow us out. I mean, if we sack, they'll blow us out.
Right. So the question is, so are we okay with...
If we attack, we have to be committed to not sacking, I think.
I think no matter what happens, we're in bad shape if they have the removal spell. I don't think any of our lines play around it, but we will, if we attack, we do have the option to just trade Kalidus with Tracker.
And get a zombie in the process. It sees
and
the...
And get a zombie in the process.
That seems good. I think we can just attack and not do anything if he walks.
Fair. All right.
Okay, I want to go for it.
Alright.
Do you not want to? I mean, we could assuredly kill the zombie with Dark Switch instead.
No, it's... The other question is, though, we could play the Colossus. How big's Colossus?
I think there's two zombies in the graveyard. So Colossus would be a 4/4.
Yeah, not big enough.
Yeah, I think going with Desolation is right. I understand if he grasps us.
Yeah.
I mean, that's still a 2-for-1. It's not, like, that bad for us.
Yeah, fair.
And if he doesn't have it, the game, I think, is pretty much over.
Alright.
So, I guess maybe he could
have three zombies because one from the Kalathas.
Yeah. Finds Ishkanah.
I feel like we can beat an Ishkanah pretty easily here.
I mean, I think Zombies often beats Ishkanah.
Yeah.
Which it's kind of why the matchup is good for us. We drew Westville Abbey.
That's a 9.
But I mean, all his... It's not like that kills him. All his guys have reach. I mean, the question is, like, if we make a... can his library beat that? I don't know if it can. But I also think we're winning, so why risk it?
Yeah, I don't want to do that. That seems crazy. How many types? 5 types? Can you take Mock Delirium?
Yeah, he's delirious.
And his cards have graveyard synergies? Because we have the Never in the graveyard.
I don't think they do. But I think... Don't we want to, like, attack first?
Well, let's play the land, because that gives us 2 Kalidus activations.
And then, I guess the question is, are we alphaing, or are we attacking just Kalidus?
I think we should alpha, because whatever he blocks with the Ishkanah, we can move on to the Kalidus.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, okay, I mean, let's... do you want to transgress him first?
He only has the thing. He only has the...
Oh, appetite. We know his only... Oh, sorry, yeah, everyone knows, you're absolutely right, yep.
Which we can take with the transgress at any point at our leisure.
Yeah. Sorry, I somehow thought we didn't know our opponent's card, but it's sitting right there.
So just make sure we have stop set inside of combat, and yeah, away we go.
Yep. We do.
Kalidus means Zircon has basically no good blocks.
Yeah, they're in a pretty tough spot.
So let's sack the one being blocked by Ishkana.
Yes. And
move it on.
I think we want to trade the one that's being blocked by the two spiders off for a spider.
I'm fine with that as well.
I just think we would rather make a different play in our post combat.
Yeah, get that Colossus down.
Yeah. It's notable, too, that since the Colossus will be 4-4, it is out of Yimini's expertise range. Perhaps not notable in this particular game because we're just very far ahead, but
yeah,
in general.
Oh, that's a nice one.
So I guess we should kill Ishkana and Alpha.
I'm just thinking it through. Yeah, I don't see any reason not to. The tracker doesn't have to chump.
You're right, because you can animate the Quagmire and block the Kalidus with it. Although then the Kalidus also makes a zombie off the Quagmire. I guess maybe a more conservative attack could be right here. Basically, the question is, what do we do if our opponent top decks Yimini's expertise?
It's not good.
Well, so like, okay, so like,
it doesn't kill any of our stuff. We have a 4-4 and a 5-6.
Say we never the Ishkana, right? And we Alpha.
Yeah.
So our opponent can go animate his Quagmire, block that on Kalidus, double block Diagraph Colossus. All our stuff dies. We get 2/2/2s from his two guys dying. The one we made from killing the Ishkana. But then if he top decks expertise, we actually lose. Well, not lose, but we're everything we have dies. But maybe that's still correct, because if he doesn't top deck it, we win, for sure. And even if he does, we have two returns in the graveyard.
I like this.
I think I like it, too. I just thought it was, like, non-trivial.
There's upside and downside, but...
Yeah. The play I'm describing for our opponent is, like, playing to their outs very hard, but I think our opponent probably like has to do that at this point.
Get one up front for killing Ishkana, and then our opponent just has to do some jumping and trading, it looks like. Just double block the Colossus, I'm thinking.
I would think so as well, but our opponent may disagree.
Oh, maybe they just want the tracker in play?
Yeah. I mean, that does give them more hits and expertise, but it also makes that expertise a lot worse.
Because it won't kill the 4-4.
Yes.
And then they'll actually, yeah.
I think I would block everything and, like, create a top deck, but I understand our opponent's line. But I think this is probably convenient time to take the appetite. Since we can't flashback. Never.
Yeah, that's fair. He could get his own clue or something.
Well, or he could get a boat. I don't know.
Yeah, fair. Right.
It's just like, I think it's unlikely that it gets better than this. I understand he's a tracker in play, but we have a lot of stuff to do with our mana. Yeah.
Close one.
What'd they draw?
Not sure. They tapped two swamps and untapped them. So that's a pretty wide range of cards that could cost mana cost, starting with two black.
That's all fun.
Well, should I cast this first to make sure we make the token?
Sure.
I mean, I don't really think it matters.
Yeah, might as well.
But,
might as well.
Because, like, I don't really know how we lose from this point, but... No reason not to.
I guess
to
if
so.
They drew, like, a grasp or something.
Well, yeah. I mean, if they drew a grasp, they probably should have main phase grasp this.
Yeah.
So, like, I don't really know if we're playing on anything, but I don't see a reason not to do so.
Alright, nothing.
Okay, cool.
Alright, on to round three with the zombie horde. Hello everybody, and welcome to round three with standard mono black zombies. I didn't see, did we win the die roll?
We lost the die
roll. We lost the die roll, and our opponent kept seven. Let's see, only one zombie. Two pushes, three lands, and a grasp. On the draw, I think this is probably a keep.
I think it's keep as well.
Yeah.
I tend to find that hands that have a lot of removal with zombies underperform a bit, but I still definitely don't want to mulligan this.
Yeah. Lands and spells will find a way to make a game of it.
Yeah. What would go really badly for us if our opponent was playing like blue-red control or something.
Oh, yeah.
Against mono-red, though, it seems actually quite good.
Kill it all. We'll probably wait to play the Relentless Dead until we can leave a mana up so we can buy it back.
Agreed.
So let's just push this thing now.
Why?
Oh, we can wait before he attacks.
We can put the let the trigger go on the stack.
That was the point. He's not sacking it. If he did.
Yeah, I think we'd be excited for him to stack it.
Yeah. I guess if our opponent plays like a Kenra, we probably want to.
We might even want to take one in case they play a post-combat Karizev.
We have two pushes.
True. So I guess it would only matter if they played a post-combat Karizev and then had another Karizev or something.
Right.
But it's like, I'm just kind of... Okay.
With the Bowmat? Alright, let's push one of the Bowmats in.
Agreed. It doesn't really matter, but it's slightly correct to let the trigger go on the stack so that you mill them another card. I don't think the mono red and zombies game could possibly come down to milling, but just in case it did for some weird reason.
Oh, that's a nice draw.
Oh yeah, let's play that.
Yep, and the fatal push up again. Love it.
Now, if our opponent just attacks without playing anything, I'm going to recommend we take one to potentially get a better target for the
yeah,
fatal
cool.
push.
I just want to push it, actually.
Well,
it's going to get to the point where we're going to have to push it anyway, because it's going to like be a draw through.
I know. The question is, what are the odds that our opponent plays a 2-drop post-combat? The answer is, last turn they played a Courier, so they probably don't have a 2-drop, because if they did, they would have played over the second Courier.
Yeah.
So therefore, I think we should
push this.
Yeah. Okay. I'm okay with this. I often find I'm rewarded for holding removal against mono red, but I think given that our opponent is very unlikely to have a card that would punish us for using it here, we should use it.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, you only, to like wait till end of turn, you only take one. Like you can take one and then still push it in turn if they don't play anything or whatever. But anyway.
Yeah. Well, we just drew more removal, so it's like we're even more happy that we did it. Didn't take the damage.
Yeah. I agree our line is working out well, although I don't think a precarious 17 life would cost us the game in as it looks now.
It might.
It could. I mean, it's possible.
Yeah. I like you held the full art one.
Well, yeah, I don't want to let him know for the full art one.
Also, we get to look at it in our hand.
That's true. It's bigger in our hand, so we get a better view.
Yeah, it's nice.
I mean, I could actually play, like, matched lands on Modo, but, that's a lot of work.
I love this card.
I love it too. I think it's a very skill intensive card.
Yeah, I'm super happy I'm going to finally get to play it in a tournament. Like a Grand Prix. I've had it in like some miscellaneous black green sideboards, but like I really like this card. I'm very happy to play it. Sweet, nice Hazoret. Prepare to get beat to death by zombies.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Well, let's attack.
Agreed.
And then I think we just want to say go?
Yeah.
I mean, we could non-lethal, like we could make a 2-2, but that seems pretty bad.
Yeah, let's not do that. Our opponent can't attack because he has more than one card in the end.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
Okay.
Carries that up, yes.
Now I assume he's going to activate the Hazoret. No, he's going to play... Okay, so I recommend we grasp this Hazoret.
Let's do it.
And then... I kind of want to just...
Grasp the carries up.
Well, I kind of don't want to do that.
No?
Well, I think the way we lose this game is another Hazoret. And I want to hold grasp for that. And I just want to take two, untap, and Dark Salvation the carries out.
Oh, yeah, that works too. I like that. Sure. I hadn't thought it all through, but that makes a lot of sense. Perfect.
So now I assume we just tap out to do this.
My goodness, zombies are so good.
I mean, if the metagame is all red decks and black-green decks, I think zombies is an inspired choice.
Well said. Well said.
Now, of course, if you make a lot of inspired choices, then you'll have a large brain and the zombies will come for you, so be careful with that.
You're like going to be the first to go in the zombie apocalypse.
Yeah, that's important to know. Zombies will not show loyalty. They're mindless.
I've seen Walking Dead a few times. They're also kind of jerks, zombies. That guy's biting everybody. It's really annoying.
I kind of want to take
two. Our opponent attacked?
Yeah. Because he can
wants to internalize make a 4-4.
It. Yeah. So I think we should take two.
Yeah.
Like, it's definitely a conservative line, and if we had less life, I perhaps wouldn't take damage so frivolously. But as the game stands, we've got plenty of life.
We have everything we need. For what it's worth, I like the Scars of Mirrodin Grasp of Darkness better than the Oath of the Gatewatcher one. What just happened?
Our opponent collective defianced our relentless dead.
Oh my goodness.
He targeted, so he dealt damage to it and damage to us. He did not cycle anyone's hand. So let's, I assume just attack for 6.
Yeah, play the swan.
I think we should ask our mono red opponent who the beatdown is.
I think our opponent is the beatdown. I just think they needed to do a better job.
Well, I mean, you're obviously right from a matchup perspective, but I do enjoy having more life than aggro decks.
What happens when you snap off those fatal pushes on the old bow mats?
Our opponent is incendiary flowing our Dreadwonder. I assume that's fine.
Do anything about it.
We could grasp in response, grasp. But
Dread Wanderer.
I think that's incorrect. If it were a Relentless Dead, we might do that, but not a Dread Wanderer.
Alright, phone's dead.
Okay.
So greedy.
Yeah, that attack was incredibly ambitious. Cool.
Alright. Time for the standard let's beat more red sideboard plan.
Yep. So this, again, these on the assumption that they're going to go big.
Yeah.
I cut this.
Mastery.
This. This is typically a sideboard in this matchup. Still think it looks pretty good.
Yeah, looks good to me.
Cool.
You can see how they board. If they have like a bunch of one drops, maybe we want the Lilianas.
Yeah, absolutely.
Who do we want these Lilianas against exactly? Like White Weenie?
So we want the Lilianas. I like them on the play in the mirror.
Okay.
I like them against Blue Red, and I like them against White Blue Monument. Okay. They're honestly not great.
Yeah, fair. Most expensive card in Standard, like sideboard card, it's not great.
It's pretty medium. The thing is, Zombies just doesn't use its sideboard space that much. Like, you don't change that many cards at a time because you're such a linear deck.
Yeah.
So as a result of that, like, it's okay to have narrow cards in your sideboard like that. I think this hand...
It's pretty bad, but it curves out with lands.
Yeah, I think we have to keep it.
Yeah. We have two shots at, like, a second card to play in the first two turns as well, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, that is true.
So, for those of you watching at home, the risk of this hand is that it just doesn't do anything on turn two and then gets too far behind and dies. But we have two draw steps, basically, to hit a card that costs one or two mana, and if we do, we'll be very happy. If we don't, it's going to be very tough. Probably lose.
I also think there's risk with this hand of flooding out, basically.
Yeah.
However,
if we draw a one or two drop, I think that, like, we probably won't flood out.
Yeah.
Because, like, we have a lot of plays to, like, impact the game.
And because, like, Deadlands turns into a spell later, yeah, and that kind of thing. Yeah, I broadly agree.
Yeah, I'm pushing that.
We'll see. There's no reason not to say go. That's fair. I think that is likely. Like, if we take two in order to potentially push a Karizev... I mean,
I don't want to take two.
We'd certainly rather push Price out, but I think this is right.
I don't want to take two.
I think if that were a Biomet Courier or a Village Messenger, taking two would have been correct. Okay, so now this is actually kind of interesting. We could not play Dread Wanderer. And the reason for that is I would really like to go Colossus into Dread Wanderer on turn four.
Let's play the Dread Wanderer.
I think it might be right not to play. Our opponent has nothing in play. Like, why play it?
So it can attack.
But, like, I think the 2-2 it will make with Diagraph Colossus will end up having more game impact than having it just randomly in play. Like, would you rather deal our opponent 4 or make a zombie token in this matchup?
So you want to play Lord of the Accursed next turn?
Yep. I was probably going to do that anyway, because I just want to bait out removal for the Colossus. Like, I don't think we need to be in a rush. If our opponent played a 2-drop here, we might have a conversation, okay? But he did nothing.
Yikes.
I think this is likely correct.
What can our opponent do on three? They could play, like, PNLR.
They could play on Crop Crasher. But...
Yeah, alright. Let's go with it.
I don't think they can do anything incredibly scary. It's also likely that given our opponent did this, their hand is, like, a mid-rangey hand. So we want to play a more mid-rangey game, kind of.
That's fair.
Basically, there's two ways to play Diagraph Colossus against Mono Red. There's, like, try to get it out of range of their spells, and there's try to get immediate value out of it.
That's fair.
The way our hand is constructed, I think we're playing the second type of game. Interesting. Off-curve Karizev. Okay, well, let's play Lord of the Cursed.
Yes.
I mean, we're at 20 life, so, like, we're gonna take, I guess, 6 from this, but that's probably fine.
We're gonna block the monkey, right?
Oh, that... Well, I was assuming our guy was dying.
Yeah, fair.
Obviously, if our opponent didn't kill it, yeah, I would agree that we should block the monkey. But I didn't think that was incredibly likely.
Monkey man.
Okay. Colossus and Dreadwander.
Yeah. Hopefully they're up 6.
Based on that pause, I don't think they are. But we should be able to Dark Salvation next turn, even if they kill the bosses. What were you saying about that?
They didn't kill our...
Oh, they didn't kill our instep. Oh, gotcha. Well, given their opponent's Incendiary Flow, they could still have an answer easily. Or like a Chandra. But that's fine. Oh, they're going to stay home here to block?
That would be wonderful.
I mean, I don't know if it's right or not from their seat. Like, all they get to do is kill a Dread Wanderer. Like, the Chandra will still die. But if they do, yeah, it'd be great for us. Because we're going to Salvation that Karizev either way.
Going down. Down, down, down.
And we also will have another Salvation for potential Hazoret.
And we have a Liliana's Mastery. We just need an answer to the Hazoret. Well, we have the answer to the Hazoret.
Yeah, Dark Salvation.
Oh my goodness.
This game is going very well. I think we should Salvation for one on the...
Yeah, Zev. I agree.
Obviously, it would have been better to draw land, but that's pretty greedy given how far ahead we are. A Glorybringer could be a problem here. Because we wouldn't have enough guys to kill it after it exerts.
We don't have to kill it. I don't think it does enough.
That might be true. Also, I guess we could probably kill it just a turn after it exerts, kind of. Okay, well now, I assume we... Oh, you don't want a Salvation, the Glorybringer? Oh, I see your point.
I don't care about that thing. It doesn't do anything.
You just think we're going to kill our opponent. Okay, I'm going to kill our opponent.
I want to save that in case they have a Hazoret. I care a lot more about Hazoret than I do Glorybringer.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough because I'm not really sure that... Yeah, yeah. I'm not sure I agree, but I definitely see your point.
Let's see? Hazoret blocks every turn. Glorybringer only kills something every other turn.
Okay, well, let's kill this Hazoret dead. And I think I cast it for the maximum.
For the max, yeah.
Yeah.
For the McVitie amount.
For the McVitie amount. This is unstoppable, even if he has a shock.
Yep. Well, for, like, multiple reasons. Our guys can't be shocked, and we have too many of them, and our opponent is just dead on board. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Perfect. We want another match.
Zombies is great.
Zombies are great. All right, welcome to round 4 with Mono Black Standard Zombies. Looks like we have a pretty... it's a pretty weak hand. 2 removal spells and 5 lands.
We're on the draw.
I think I would shift this. It's just too many lands. A hand of 6 is going to be better.
I think it's close because one of them is Dark Salvation. Like, we could, like, cast Dark Salvation on 5. We have the Deadlands from Flooding. To clarify, I'm not necessarily saying it is a keep.
What decks is this hand good against? Are there any?
No, probably not.
Okay. Are there hands that this hand is actively bad against? Decks that are, it's bad against?
Yes, there are. Okay, we can mulligan.
I think it's a mulligan.
I just wanted to think about it. I think you're right. Okay, so we're on the draw. We get a scry. This isn't out of the question, okay? I
colorless land, all double black spells.
I understand your point. We do have 22 black sources. If we
I
keep.
Agree.
Like, the question is this better than the average 5 on the draw with the scry? I don't think it's good.
I think 5's going to be better for us.
Wait a minute. Hear me out.
We won out of mold of 4.
We also have Crypt Breaker, so, like, we can... even if we can't play a spell, we can, like, discard stuff to make 2/2s. And then, like, use the Crypt Breaker to draw cards to, like... this will be, like... I actually want to keep this hand.
You want to keep it?
But I
would mulligan this, but if you want to keep it...
Well, God, it's so bad. The fact that it has 3 gold black cards in it...
The other problem is that when you don't mulligan, because you probably should, and you brick off and lose, I'm just going to mock you the rest of the tournament.
Yeah, that is a big downside that I need to consider. Okay, I guess we can mulligan.
If you really think we should keep, I won't mock you if we don't make it. Like, if you think this is a keep, let's keep it.
I think it's...
I would mulligan it, but I...
Okay, wait, can we do a little math?
Yeah, let's do math.
So, We have 22 black sources in a 54 card deck. So I'm going to round that to 50-50.
Sure.
So we're 50-50 to hit a land. So off a scry and a thing, we're 75% hit the first swamp.
Okay.
Then from that point forward, we're only a coin flip each additional turn. So our odds of hitting a swamp and then hitting another land swamp is like 75 times 50. It's like better than even, but not great. It's like 60-something percent.
The problem is, I think if we brick... How many times can we brick before we just lose the game?
Not many. Well,
how many times can we brick on... Like, assuming we
brick,
hit the
If we hit the first swamp, then we play Krippiger. Then we play West Flabby. We discard a double black card. We make a 2-2. Then we can even cast our Salvation to kill something for 0, if we want. Or we can make another 2-2 by discarding another card.
Well... Also, what if the Krippbreaker dies?
Like, oh, well, then we're dead. And yeah, obviously, calculating over all of standard, the probability the Krippbreaker on one dies is... Okay, okay, I
think this is a mulligan.
I think it's close.
I think it's close, too, but I think it's
mulligan. On 7, I'd snap mullet, obviously, but... Oh, wow, our hand is great.
Yeah.
Wow, Brian, your play of mulligan was genius.
You want this 5 drop?
I think it's, you know, a tough call.
They'll ship it.
Here, by the way, I definitely think we should play Krippbreaker on 1 because we have cards that we want to discard.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like this is the mirror.
Doing it.
Now, in the mirror, it's important to note that our opponent... Oh, no. Okay, never mind. I don't know what's going on anymore.
Black-green delirium or +1/+1 sneak, guys.
He just played a Contraband Kingpin, right?
Oh my god, we're so dead.
So I think now we just want to discard Dread Wanderer and make a 2-2.
Yeah.
Because I think it's just better to have that in the graveyard and a 2-2 in play.
Yeah.
So I'll just pass the turn.
You don't want to attack?
For a minute there, I was like, what the heck are you talking about? Like, am I missing something here?
Yeah.
You did briefly.
It's not a very good attack.
Thanks, Brian.
Oh, my lord.
I don't know what's going on at all in the game that we're playing.
We're in big trouble. We have to go very big. And I don't feel like this person is going to let us go very big. Although they didn't kill our Krippbreaker, so we're going to get to draw a card with it.
I do like drawing cards.
It's like my favorite thing. Second favorite thing. Do you know what my favorite thing in all of Magic is?
What?
Winning.
Hmm. That's a good choice of favorite thing. So I think we might want to cast... Well, I don't really know how much removal our opponent's deck plays. If our opponent was playing a deck with significant amounts of removal, I definitely want to play Lord of the Curse first to bait it out. But I'm not sure that he is. I don't know what his deck... I don't know what cards are in his library. What do you think? Which one do you want to play? Like, does it seem like a sort of deck that might be like Removal Light?
No.
I think I agree. So I think I want to play Lord of the Cursed.
I think so too.
And then we're definitely going to draw a card.
Yeah. Honor opponent's end step.
Oh, yeah. I think it's really weird that Krippbreaker, like, turns zombies into card draw. I don't really understand the flavor. Is it, like, you get enough zombies together and they're, like, all brainless, but then, like, together they form a hive mind? I don't really understand the flavor of Krippbreaker.
You're like, it breaks the Crypt Mirror.
Thanks, Brian.
It breaks every matchup.
Breaks them wide open.
Because you're just
open.
Like, oh, we'll just draw cards. Glint Nest Crane.
Oh, Prophetic Prism. I think this might be a Metawork Colossus deck.
Is that bad for us or good for us?
I don't know. I have no experience in that.
We should have played the other Colossus guy.
Well, now I think that, but it wasn't obvious to me that that's what he was playing last turn.
Yeah.
But now I think that's true. Because this, I think this is a dead giveaway.
Land. Darn.
Well,
so now we should play the Colossus.
I think I agree. I was wondering if you wanted to make any attacks first.
Do we have any creature that's big enough to attack?
No, not really. So I think I agree. Colossus.
And then draw a card.
We want to do it main phase because we draw land.
Yeah.
Okay, that seems reasonable. So we should not tap whatever creature we want to block with most, which is zombie token.
Yep. Darn.
Okay. Pass turn.
I feel like we're in big trouble now.
I think we're in big
trouble. But this is a mold of five, so...
Yeah, I
we had two more cards, we would have been in much better shape.
Oh, God.
Right now we're dead.
Yeah, that's very bad for us. He doesn't need a Colossus. That's going to be this on its own.
I guess we should have played the second Lord.
I don't know if that's true. The thing is, like, you really need to go fast in this match. Like, I think you have to go pretty big and pretty quick in this matchup, so, like, it's kind of a trade-off. Anyway, now we cast Lord.
Yeah.
We can't really attack, because if we attack with anything...
We're just dead, because the boat is just going to eat our thing every turn.
I do see your point. Let's
draw. Let's just play, man. Yeah, let's draw a card, and let's just keep playing. Because I don't even know if he's definitely a Colossus deck or not. I see, like, is that Sanctum of Ugin?
Well, yeah, I think
that goes and gets the Colossus.
I think that makes sense in a Colossus deck.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, it triggers off Colossus and goes and gets Colossus. I admit I think it'll be very hard for us.
What's the crew on the Sky Sovereign?
Well, it's three, but he can crew the Harvester and use it to crew the boat.
Maybe we should have left up grass.
Why?
Or it doesn't do anything, does it?
Not really, no. I mean, Boat is an extremely good card against zombies. We have Boat in our sideboard for the zombie's mirror. That's like, fair. It's not shocking that Boat is great against us. It's just unfortunate. Red mana. What is happening?
Look out of braided?
The Lord be cursed. Our opponent also has Inventor's Fair, which can find the Colossus. I think this is Colossus. I think this is blue-black... Kingpin Colossus, or Grixis Kingpin Colossus. There's a Colossus. Okay. We are also now dead.
What if we draw land and draw, like, Mastery?
I think that would not be anywhere near good enough.
Oh, that's a lot of 10-10s.
Our opponent controls two 10-10s in addition to the artifacts that we almost certainly can't beat either.
Alright, that's good.
I agree.
I've seen enough. Alright, what's the...
So, obviously, I don't have any experience against Colossus, so we're going to be kind of playing by ear. I think transgresses are certainly good. We want to disrupt him. We want to take his key pieces. I think Doomfalls are likely good, but worse than transgress. I'm not as sure they're good. I think the kill spells are almost all pretty bad.
Yeah.
Like, Dark Salvation might be fine, because I'm fine with, like, making a 2-2 and randomly killing Kingpin or whatever, but, like, the others...
I think
like
we should board out the Dark Salvation.
It's too slow. I can imagine that. We'll see. Let's see if we have anything worse. Do we want boats of our own? I guess not. They're not great. Do we want to be able to kill Contraband Kingpin? Perhaps not. Basically, I'm not even sure we want Cletus. Basically, we need to play four of these cards. I'm not sure which four they are.
I think we want to kill the Contraband Kingpin.
So you want Fatal Push to do that efficiently?
Yeah. And then one Cletus.
Hold on, why Cletus?
Because I don't want any of the other.
I kind of want Salvation. It's just an extremely powerful card. It can kill things for one mana. It can, for three mana, take out a lot of stuff.
I don't think it does anything. All their guys are, like, vehicles and high toughness.
Well,
it's just, like, a bad mana.
It's true. Cletus, huh?
Yeah.
Is that better than, like, a flying vehicle?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Like, that at least, if they don't have, like, a direct removal spell, could theoretically, like, just do something big.
This hand is not very good.
I agree.
I'm not sure it's a mulligan, though.
I think
it's a mulligan. I guess it's 2 5 drops and 2 lanes. Yeah, okay, it's probably a mulligan.
Can't even cast our 2 drop.
Oh, all right, man.
Alright. Down 5.
Well, yeah, we're in 5.
Keep it.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a keep, but it's okay. Yeah, discard
land. Yeah, now here we go.
I mean, we're also that on the play, like, so we don't have to play it on one. But you know, we have mulliganed quite a bit this event. We've been on 4-5-5 over the course of the event so far, but such is magic. If I wanted to no variance game, options exist. Put this crane, sure. Phoenix Prism. Okay. I mean, we still get to draw a card this turn, but
that's.
I think I should probably play the Deadlands, actually. Because
yeah.
I might want to discard all my other lands. And say go.
Seems good.
Good is a strong word. Oh wow, our opponent's mismatched Prophetic Prism Arts. I mean, I know I'm saying that where I have mismatched swamps, but still.
I don't know what to do. We need help. We need more cards.
Yeah. We're going to break into the crypt and hope there are some cards in there.
Oh, is that what he does? He breaks into the crypt?
Look.
Did you just solve it?
Yeah, there's hidden knowledge in the crypt, Brian. And he breaks in and he takes the hidden knowledge out and then he uses it for his own game. Kalidus.
That's right.
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to use him to make 2/2s this turn. Because we could, like, discard a land to make a 2/2, draw a card.
I just want
to,
like,
but I think...
Well, we should wait to draw the card and just cast Kalidus.
You don't think there's any card you want to play over Kalidus?
On 4? No. We can't get, like, Duress or whatever.
I think there's no reason not to draw a card. Well, just because, like...
We'll be hellbent. We probably can't Duress us.
Okay, wait, let's think about it. So, if we drew Diagraph Colossus, would you rather play that? Because I kind of think I might.
Alright. I guess you're right.
I only have to name one for it to be correct, since I think it's very unlikely our opponent has Duresses. Okay, Kalidus. But those crypts, they're wide open, Brian.
What if wide we win open. Because we drew this one of Kalidus?
That would be kind of great.
Just can't beat it.
I think that is pretty unlikely, but... See, by my count, 10-10 is bigger than 3-4.
Well, right now...
I just thought I should inform you of the math.
I mean, 10-10 will always be bigger than 3-4, but Kalidus doesn't have to be a 3-4 forever. He could be bigger.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, all we need is, like, a 5-6 Kalidus, and it negates, like, 1-10-10, because we can just sit there and draw cards for the rest of our life.
True. This looks to be a pretty good draw from our opponent, though. The 10-10 might be rapidly upcoming.
Just keep doing our thing. Keep drawing our cards.
So I think I probably want to play the Crypt Breaker and tap the 3 Crypt Breaker. Or I guess that doesn't matter. Probably want to play Crypt Breaker and tap Crypt Breaker Zombie to draw a card.
Let's just draw the card first, because we could draw, like, Mastery.
Oh, that's true. I was thinking we might want to make a 2-2 with the Crypt Breaker, though. So if we play the Crypt Breaker first, then we can make a 2-2 with one of the other non-Sunnyside Crypt Breakers. Oh, but then we can't use Kalidus. You think you want to use Kalidus immediately. Is that right?
I want to draw a Mastery is what I want to do.
You just think we want to make a better play than the one we have.
Yeah.
Okay, I think that logic makes some sense.
We could also draw, like, a Diagraph Colossus and make two guys.
Okay. That's decent. So I'm probably going to cast that.
Let's just do all these things.
Do you want to play the land?
Yeah.
I think so, yeah. Okay. Well, we can attack first, because it's not a zombie. And our opponent won't know what's happening. Now, it is conceivable that our opponent boarded in a sweeper of some sort, but I don't think that we have the luxury of playing around it.
So I think if they have a sweeper, we're dead no matter what, so...
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I was just noting that, like...
Oh, maybe we're not, because we have the Kalidas.
We have to actually kill them before they do their thing.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, it's like... Like, I'm going to cast this too, I think.
Yeah, might as well.
It's like, if we're not pressuring our opponent, I think we're just going to lose, and... I understand that this exposes us to a sweeper beating us, but I mean, we mold the five, like, we're not in a great spot. Like, I think we don't have the luxury of trying to play around it. Plus, like, imagine we control a five's Kalidas, he sweeps us, then he plays a Colossus. We're still losing in that spot, like, even though the Kalidas is still in play.
Well, not necessarily, because we could make the Kalidas a 5-6, and then he can't attack Tenta.
Well, it's never 1-10-10, though, Brian.
Yeah, it's true. Just thinking.
I understand the point you're making about Kalidas, like, being able to kind of sort of race, but... So he's 9 right now, so he can cast it right now, right? For 2 mana. I think that's right. Because 3, 7, 8, 9, it is 11 CMC, so it costs 2 mana. He has 2 mana. So we need to draw a Never Return or something now. Some way to kill the Colossus.
We should draw 2 cards.
Yeah.
We should start by drawing a cheap zombie.
That would be very skillful on our part. Well, we can take another Colossus. I mean, it's actually...
Oh, yeah, good point.
Not irrelevant. Oh, God.
I thought he had another Colossus. Wait. Oh, he must have
tutored. He declined to sack. I'm sorry. He just didn't want to sack.
I feel like we should take that TP.
Oh, God. So you want to let ourselves get Kozlex returned?
Oh. I didn't see that.
Because our opponent could next turn... Well, oh, man. His hand is so good. I think we need to take those looks return.
I do too. Alright, let's take those looks return.
I don't think this line is winning per se, but I think it's probably right.
Let's draw a card.
I think I'm going to use Zombie Crypt Picker, Crypt Picker.
Yep.
Okay. I think I'm going to transgress our opponent again.
Yeah, let's take the Deep Fiend, I think.
Yeah, you think that's better than taking the Kalidas, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Say go. I mean, we're still probably losing, but it wasn't bad. One of the problems that we have is that our opponent can still Worldbreaker and trigger the Sanctum and find another Metalwork or what have you. This is quite a mana base.
Yeah.
Okay. So what does it look like for us to win this game? It has to be like... some weird stuff has to happen. I don't think we're in a great spot.
Like, we have to jump here. Or we can't jump.
We have to take 10.
Yeah.
It's not pleasant. I don't like doing it. I think we need to take 10.
Yeah. We should have left the zombie back, because the zombie could have jumped the metalwork bosses.
Well, we didn't... Oh, yeah, that's your point. We actually knew he had to play for that point. That's true. Okay.
Well, we can attack the Dark Elitis.
Yeah, let's start there. He doesn't have any good blocks on it. And then I kind of want to sack something to it. Like, tap the three Cryptbreakers, draw a card, and then sack one. Can I tap the Cryptbreakers now to see what we see?
Well, we want to sacrifice the zombie token so he doesn't get anything off Kalidas.
Oh. You're right, I suppose. So you think I should tap Cryptbreaker zombie token and sack the zombie token? Or you think I should actually just wait till his turn is active?
I want to chump block yeah. with the zombie token.
Okay, that's fair. So you think I should just blow and take three?
Yeah.
No, I think you're right. And then I'll tap these.
Yep. Hopefully we draw like another something or other.
Hopefully we draw a swamp, is that what you're saying, Brian?
Yeah. I was hoping we drew like another cheap zombie. Swamp's just as good as
it's basically the same.
Actually,
more or less.
It's actually much worse. This Gluttonous Crane should have just been attacking every turn.
Well, for some of the early turns, they were holding back our attacks, but I agree that as of late, they should have been attacking. Wow, this is really not very good for us, Brian.
Plan is that our Kalidas needs to be bigger than 10 times.
Oh, that's quite a plan. And he's got to get there while there's an opponent that has a Kalidas out.
Yeah, I think we're dead now. Why are there so many Colossus? Oh, he drew a Colossus for the turn?
He drew a Colossus for the turn, played it, sacked the Sanctum for another Colossus.
I see. Well, isn't that just so lucky?
I mean, it is, although I don't think we'd be in good shape if our opponent just cast Worldbreaker and then sacked the Sanctum and then found a Colossus.
We're dead.
I don't not agree. I mean, sack this. We probably have no outs. Doesn't seem likely. That point can even like draw two cards with each one. Well, okay, so we can make another zombie with Cryptbreaker in order to block.
And then sad.
Yeah. That's definitely what we're gonna do. So I think I should say go here.
Yeah.
But I admit that I think we are probably dead. Like, I'm not really sure if we could possibly win the spot. And our opponent's gonna, like, even, like, draw two with the archive, and they have, like, Cultivator's Caravan to crew, and...
We're done. It's over.
Like, there have probably, in the history of Magic, been people who have a smaller percent chance to win the game than we do presently, but those people were probably, like, literally dead on board.
Did any of them win?
Well, yeah. I don't know, Brian.
Yeah, I've seen some punts before, but...
I mean,
it'd be hard to, like, punt your way out of this game.
You know, I mean, our opponent could have some important real-life event come up, and then they could have to leave the screen, and then they could time out. That's about the only way we could win at this point.
So you're, like, hoping something terrible happens to our opponent in real life?
No, it could be something pleasant, but time-sensitive.
Oh, so you're hoping, like that guy who comes to your door and gives you a giant check is, like, coming over to our opponent's house and just being like, here's $1 million?
And they're like, why the heck am I playing Moto? I have $1 million. That's what I'm hoping.
Oh, man, look at this guy's deck. The guy would come to the door with $1 million and be like, hold on, I gotta crush these zombies real quick. I'll be right back. Just stay outside.
Okay, so we can block this.
That's a strong block. What's next?
We can jump block this.
Also strong.
And, while we can't recur our Relentless Dead, I guess jump off with our other Cryptbreaker?
Very nice.
Our opponent has chosen this turn to leave home the Glutinous Cranes. I'm not precisely sure why they have chosen that. And, you know, it is their prerogative to choose that, if that is what they wish. Yeah, Brian, I would never wish something terrible happens to my opponent just to win a game of Magic. That would be very mean.
I was just clarifying. That's what it sounded like. But I've always known you to be a pretty nice guy. I wouldn't do that. Why are we still playing this game?
Okay, yeah, I agree. We're done here.
Yeah, that's good. What is 30 10-10s in play? And a kill.
Okay.
All right. We died. But one more to go.
Welcome back to the final round of Standard Mono Black Zombies League. We lost the die roll. We are currently 3-1. We were defeated by Metalwork Colossus, Colossi, and now we have a new hand. What do you think?
I think this is on the low end of keepable. I don't think our hand is good.
I would ship this, I think. I think it's just too weak.
I mean, the reason I kind of want to keep is that both Relentless Dead and In Your Deadlands provide flooding insurance.
Not if you play the Relentless Dead on turn 2.
But we just would. It's like if we mull. Maybe you're right. Okay, I'm into mull. I think our hand is probably worse than the average 6. It's close, though. I think it's close to the average 6.
Way better.
Well, I agree. This is an above average 6. Our opponent mulled to 5.
Perfect.
I will bottom that.
Let's bottom that.
They also bottomed. Which probably doesn't affect our play, but in case it does.
Evolving Wilds. The main phase Evolving Wilds.
Plains. I don't know what that means. What deck plays Evolving Wilds and Plains?
This is a mystery.
Spire Bluff Canal.
It's like a Jeskai control deck?
Maybe. Let's attack for 2.
Whoa. Oh, yeah, never mind.
This comes in play tap, so we can't. Yeah. And then I just want to play Dreadwander and not play Crypt Breaker, so we can play Crypt Breaker and draw a card in the same turn.
Well, we could play a 3 draw Breaker.
Well, that's true if we draw a land. But I'm also not sure you would want to play that 3 drop even if we did draw the land.
I just want to play both.
Why?
Because we're not, if they have a shock, we're not drawing a card no matter what, so who cares?
Well, but then we make them spend a shock on a Dreadwander. Like, you play the Crypt Breaker on the stack, they have to shock Dreadwander. I'm kind of happy about that. Basically, I think that if we're playing its control deck, which is my guess right now, I want to eke every bit of value out of our cards. And to eke every bit of value out of Crypt Breaker, I should not play it here. So I play it here, the shock will go to the Crypt Breaker instead of the Diagraph, the Dreadwander.
All right, let's try it.
If our opponent is not playing a control deck, this is perhaps not the right play, but I think that is what he's playing. Cool. Mission accomplished. Okay.
This is a disaster.
I understand what you're saying, but if we'd made the other play, he just would have Harness Lightning Crypt Breaker.
Oh, we'd be attacking for 4, though, at least.
Well, okay, sure, but, like, assuming he has a kill spell, he would just kill one of them in that spot there.
Yeah.
And he doesn't have a kill spell, Crypt Breaker's going to live.
I think it's not because of that play that I think we're wrecked or not wrecked. I just think we're wrecked.
Okay. I agree with the statement that we are losing.
Yeah. Slay Cole?
Okay. Yep. Our opponent is indeed playing a Jeskai control deck, it looks like. Which is probably not a great matchup for us.
I think it would be.
Okay, well, let's attack for 2 and make it 2-2 on his end step.
Yeah.
Our opponent does only have 3 cards in his hand. Remember that he did mull as well.
Oh, right, that's true. Maybe we can steal this one.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think we're, like, in a great spot to win, but I don't think we're drawing dead here. So, obviously we can see what our opponent does, but do you think we should discard Liliana's Mastery or Fatal Push? It's tough because we're very far from casting this, but this card is almost blank.
Let's discard the Mastery.
You think we might end up wanting to push a mainland?
Yeah.
Okay. I can see that. I mean... Ooh, we drew a land. Well, we should play the land.
I agree.
And then it gets interesting.
Maybe we should bitch. Oh, we can draw cards, though.
We can draw cards. We can also make a 2-2, then draw cards. We have a lot of options. I think we should probably make a 2-2. So our opponent had a kill spell he wanted to use. He would have used it on his turn. Like, instead of letting us untap here, right?
Yeah.
So, like, it's safe to tap the Crypt Breaker. Because if he kills a guy in response, he would have already done that. So, we tap the Crypt Breaker, we discard Fatal Push, we make a 2-2, and then I think we want to draw a card.
Why don't we do this all on our opponent's end step? So that if they have a sweeper...
Well, because if they have a sweeper, it's the same. It's the same. And yeah. our opponent doesn't have a kill spell right now. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
So given that, I don't want them to draw a kill spell and then be able to use it. In response to discard.
So you want to pitch...
Fatal Push.
Fatal Push, draw a card?
Yeah.
Alright, let's do it. We play land?
Yeah, we did.
Okay.
And the next turn, we might honestly want to start bashing. We might have reached that point. Glimmer? Archangel Avacyn. Okay. This is a weird deck. I don't know what that means.
Yeah, me either.
I mean, we do have this grass port, so it'll probably be fine, but...
Might get backed up by, like, a counter spell, though.
I know. But there's not much we can do about that. Like, I assume I'm just supposed to go land grasp. Because I kind of want to bash if it works. I understand that lets him spend mana on our turn. Maybe that's wrong. Maybe I should just say go. Land go. What are your thoughts?
I'm trying to figure it out. I don't exactly know what to do.
Basically, here's the thing. If our opponent is a second Archangel Avacyn, it's very bad for us to grasp the Avacyn, but he also only has two cards in hand and almost certainly doesn't have a sweeper. So there's also an argument he made for striking while the iron is hot. Just like, play a land, attack for six, go.
Let's play the land, because we're doing it no matter what.
That I agree with.
What if we just go like Colossus Crypt Breaker and try and draw two cards? I don't think our opponent can flip this Avacyn.
And you don't think they have sweeper, else they would have cast it last turn.
Right.
Actually, if they do have the
sweeper, it's not that bad because we're drawing two cards.
Okay. I'm okay with this line. Should I cast this first in case of sensor? Yeah, that makes sense.
Well, also because you want to get the free zone.
Yeah, that was crazy. There's no reason. Obviously, I cast first. I apologize. Yeah, we certainly want to get the free zombie. Opponent could easily respond to this by killing something. If they don't, I have no idea what's in our opponent's hand. Well, I have no idea what's in our opponent's hand.
All right.
Let's say go.
As long as they don't have a flash creature they can kill at instant speed, we're in really good shape.
Yeah, I think it is unlikely that our opponent has spell color, kill spell, kill spell color. Supreme Will. They're digging for a sweeper. That could be very bad for us. But also, I guess, partially depends on what the sweeper is. If it's sweltering, so it's a lot worse. Radiant Flames. Or that. That's really bad, too.
Two cards. Like, there's nothing we could do about this. Like, we invested two cards and we drew two cards. Like, what more do you want?
Yeah, I understand your point. We slightly reduced our card quality by looting away good cards, but obviously it pays off if our opponent does not find the sweeper. So, I don't think it was unreasonable. Now I think, though, we need to kill this Avacyn right now. So this cannot continue. We're at 9 life.
Okay.
Like, I also think,
is
like...
Is this what we have? We didn't get a land out of all those draws plus our draw step?
Yeah.
Alright. They may have Spellcaller for this.
Yeah, I don't think our opponent has Spellcaller on their deck, but I agree that's possible.
Yeah.
If they do, I don't think we're beating it, though.
So. Yeah, alright.
Or negate.
Did you hear the negate is not a good card right now? Yeah, we're
good. I think so. I mean, our opponent's only one card. If we top deck a removal spell for the angel, maybe we can win.
I don't think we were getting beaten this no matter what. It felt like our opponent just had a counter spell the whole time.
What is happening? Oh god. That's really good. Okay, that reduced our outs, because now we cannot draw a second Dark Salvation in order to kill the Archangel Avacyn. Oh, sorry, I have to declare target. We just have to draw Grasp, or we die, I guess? Okay, we didn't. I guess I'll cast Colossus. And then Cryptbreaker.
Yeah.
And then go to 1. I guess this is not... We're not literally 0% at this point. Dark Colossus is an 8-8. I don't think that's going to matter, but it is true.
I mean, I guess we could Dark Salvation the Avacyn next turn, right?
Yeah, that definitely is our plan. The problem is that, like, if our opponent ever draws a Shock, we die. And they have Shock in their deck.
Yeah. What do you want from me, man? Like, these are cards we have.
No, I know.
Oh my goodness.
Torrential Gear Hulk? Yeah. Parting Shock? Yeah.
Okay. Alright, well, we get more games, and maybe we can not mulligan to 5. We mulled to 5 again, right?
Yeah, that's right. So, against a very controlling deck like this, we definitely want all 6 discard spells. I think we probably want Never Return as our kill spell of choice, because it kills Gear Hulk and the Angel. I understand that Grasp kills Angel, but I also think our opponent probably doesn't have that many copies of Angel in their deck,
right?
Just based on how the deck looks. This is definitely a matchup where we want Liliana, just as a value card. Grasp is bad. Dark Salvation is not good. It's not awful, though.
It's terrible. It's, like, probably worse than the other than Grasp.
I don't think it's worse than Grasp. 5 mana to make 2/2/2s is decent in this matchup. This card is very bad, so you don't overdo it into Wrath.
I like that card. That card's fine.
I think it tends, like, to be bad against Dex.
Like, if you get the Liliana Mastery down first, you can, like, have insurance against, like, I don't know, I think it's just,
I think,
like,
that's a dream, because our opponent will have Hour of Devastation and or Fumigate. Since
I'd rather have that card than Dark Salvation.
I just like Dark Salvation.
Just, you just want it to, like, make 2 guys?
Yes. I think it's a 2-for-1. I mean, I don't love it or anything.
Our opponent's deck is full sweeper, so...
Well, if it 1/1's a sweeper, I'm happy. Oh, Gifted Aetherborn is probably bad in this matchup. It's the vanilla guy.
Yeah.
It's probably worse than
I agree with that.
So you want to play 3 Lord of the Accursed instead of 3 Dark Salvations. Is that right?
How about a split?
How about a split? Okay. I mean, I want to make sure we have some answers to the Angel. Maybe, like...
Alright, that's a good point. Alright. Yeah, let's just leave all the Dark Salvations in.
Well, maybe, like, this? Maybe 3 of them? I don't really want to draw 2. I think this might be about right.
The Lord is, like, triggers the Diagraph Colossus too, which is relevant. I don't want either Spirit Harvester in the deck. Why do you want that?
Well, it pressures walkers, it blocks Avacyn.
But it doesn't have walkers.
Well,
they could have Chandra.
They probably have some Chandra. I don't know if it's 6 or 4. I have actually found this card to be good against blue-red control. I don't know much about blue-white-red.
Okay.
But I think this card is going to be better than you would expect. All
right. I feel like okay about this.
I think maybe this is better.
No more Kalathos, actually?
We could bring in the 3rd Kalathos. It lives 2 red flames.
I want that.
Yeah, actually, no, I think you're right. 2 Dark Salvation, so 4 answers. Yeah, I think about 2 is about right. I want a little salvation in the mix.
You want the play or the draw?
I want the play.
Sure?
Yes. Honestly, Brian, I believe the time to draw in Magic is past. I don't think it's interesting.
All right.
I will keep this.
Yep.
Like, I don't remember the last time I drew... I guess I have chosen to draw Unlimited in a control mirror before, recently, but it's vanishingly rare. Oh, cool. Let's transgress him.
Let's play the...
I don't want to expose that. I want to take his Glimmer and leave him with just the Gear Hulk. You have nothing until then. And now we can be a lot more aggressive because we know he doesn't have anything.
Relentless Bit?
Yeah, I think that's right. I was thinking about it, but yeah, I think that's correct. Countering it? No, he's cycling near his farmland. Sure. Crypt Breaker. Interesting. So now we could slam two guys and draw a card. We'd be tapped out of Relentless Dead. That makes me kind of unhappy.
Yes.
I think I'd rather just play Lord and Attack 3.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, he's getting Supreme Build. Okay. I don't think I want to play Crypt Breaker still.
I'm with it.
That's the Aether Hub, and they play the Island 2. Liana. Okay, that could be good. Let's attack.
Yep.
I'm not sure what our play is going to be post-combat.
I don't either.
We've got a lot of options. I think typically in the sort of matchup, slow-rolling Crypt Breaker is correct. Our opponent currently has Gear Hulk and 3 unknowns, though, so like, Slamming it here is probably better than slamming it in an average spot.
What, Heartbreaker?
Yeah. We also just play the Liana in
minus. I want to play like a more mana intensive play.
I kind of like Liana minus.
To get back the Lord?
Yeah. I mean, not because I particularly want Lord, but just because.
Yeah, alright. Let's try that. I like that.
I guess it could also be Liana plus.
We're not going to be able to do that. We don't have time.
Okay, he countered it, so it's poison move. I still don't think I want to play Crypt Breaker.
No, it doesn't do anything.
Okay, that's good. Let's attack.
Yep. Play Kalthas?
Kind of.
Doesn't really do much, is the problem.
Yeah. Well, it means if he Gear Hulks and we never it, then it's good for us. But.
If he what?
If he Gear Hulks, then we can we kill it, it's good for us, but.
Well, he's not gonna do that.
Yeah. Well, the other line, we could just play Dread Wander and say go.
Why don't we play both of our guys? Or, no, let's play Dread Wanderer. That way the Gear Hulk is a complicate. I have to pay 3 so we can force the Crypt Breaker in.
Yes, yeah. Okay, I like this. Although, of course, he can choose the other one on Super Wheel.
Yeah, but that's fine.
I think I agree.
Because then we'll just draw a card and kill his Torrential Gear Hulk.
Yes. Oh god, that's very good for our opponent.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's cast this.
Magic can be kind of cruel sometimes. Our opponent had no spells except the six drop. Couldn't put them away.
Yeah. Let's draw a card.
Yeah.
You're not wrong. It is unfortunate. Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, he's going to Gear Hulk in response, but that's life in the big city. I don't know if he's going to counter it or Glimmer. Probably Glimmer.
Glimmer and just not draw big things, but hopefully there's two Gear Hulks in the group there.
I don't know if that's what I hope, fortunately. Oh, he's countering it.
Oh, he countered it.
Yeah.
That's probably really bad for us, actually. I would rather...
I'm not sure what I would rather... It's
I think it means that there's another Gear Hulk in our bones.
That is definitely what it... That definitely could mean that, yeah.
Which is going to be tough because we can't...
It doesn't matter. We have to we have to never this Gear Hulk.
Nope. I think we, like, probably die if we do that. It's just going to get countered.
Okay, so you think I should slam Kalidus and say go.
Well, I'm thinking about, like, just discarding a card to make a guy.
Why?
So, our opponent can't counterspell anything this turn. Like, how are we going to win if we get counterspelled here and our opponent has 2 5-5s and we're really...
I do not believe your claim that we can beat a Gear Hulk. If we make a 2-2, what will happen is our opponent will Gear Hulk and end of turn and cast Glimmer of Genius. And draw into more gas. Like, you're claiming that, like...
That's fair.
Basically, if we could discard Kalidus to counter a Glimmer of Genius, I think we would do that. So...
Alright, let's play Kalidus then.
I don't, like where we're at. I just... I don't think any of our lines is remotely acceptable against Gear Hulk. Okay, resolved.
So, let's do nothing.
It's a strong follow. I like it. Note that we also can chump block with the relentless set and just pay one if we want to at some point. I'm not saying we want to do that like immediately, but it's like an option available to us. Oh god. Okay. Well, good thing we can go for the kill swamp, Linky Rock.
I think we should probably block with the Thrall instead here.
We could also gang block.
Oh, that's too risky.
Oh, I guess Labs would also flip. Yeah, I'm off that.
So this is pretty tough. I don't.
Oh, I think we're in a bad spot. I think we are unlikely to win the game from this point. Not impossible, but probably quite unlikely. We need our opponent to, like, have nothing where we draw well.
Draw a card. Maybe a little grass would be nice.
We don't have grass.
No, we don't have grass.
We do have Dark Salvation, which would kind of work.
Right,
yeah. But, yeah. Okay, this happens... Table to bring it back. Okay. I think we need to never be Addison. I just don't think we're winning if we don't do that.
All right, let's do it.
If it gets countered, that's very unfortunate, but, like...
Yeah, we'll die.
Okay.
Success.
Now, attacks. I think we might want to attack with just Kalidus. I also don't think we're beating another Gear Hulk, so I'm not going to worry about it.
Those two cards?
They also don't have it, because they had another Gearhulk, they would have countered that never, for sure. They would snap. They would flashback Supremo in a heartbeat.
That's a good point. All right, let's do it. It makes sense.
Now we could actually also attack with. I guess I should play this first to gain information about like.
Yeah.
Because we could attack with other things as well, and we may as well know like what's going to happen. I guess it's actually true that our opponent could block the Cletus with this and swap and trade.
Oh yeah, I don't want that to happen.
I guess maybe I should not attack. Again.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Things are not going well, but I think that's reasonable. I mean, maybe our opponent actually has nothing. I mean, it's not that easy to imagine a card they wouldn't have cast on their turn or on our turn, or like at some point. Oh, okay. Or we're incredibly dead.
Yeah.
That's like, you know, like being alive. I mean, except for the life part.
Yeah.
So when our opponent attacks, I will chump block the Torrential Gearhawk with Dread Wanderer. And I will draw a card, I guess. Oh, God.
So our opponent has one card in hand. If we can find an answer to the Zavacen, I think we might be okay.
Yeah, there's a chance. We might be okay.
We have to chump block.
Yeah. Dread Wanderer, though, is a good chump blocker. He's the place of strengths. He's firing up the Fumarole, okay? So I'm going to chump block with Dread Wanderer and block with a zombie token, I think. Like, what do you think about this block?
I like it.
I mean, actually, I could try to take the Fumarole down to get a zombie with Cletus. Is that crazy? If I double lock with, like, this, I would trade both my guys for it, though. I'd trade both my guys for it, but I'd get a 2-2. That's what happened. Actually, that seems pretty reasonable. Like, obviously, I guess he has a kill spell. Well, then it's still, he has to swap for them to trade. It's not even that bad against a kill spell.
Yeah, don't block with two things.
Why? I kind of think it's right.
Because he's going to trade no matter what.
So he's going to swap and trade for two guys, right? And then we get a zombie. So we're essentially trading Relentless Death.
He's going to switch it, I think, no matter what.
I agree. So he's going to switch it.
So why do you want to lose two guys instead of just one?
Because I get a zombie.
You get a zombie either way. It's a 4-1.
No. If I block with one guy, he's not going to swap.
Why would he attack with it if he's not planning on swapping?
Nice, your point.
Don't block with two. He's trying to get you off of Crypt Breaker. He's trying to, like, lock you off a Crypt Breaker.
Oh, no, wait. Wait. Hold on. He's going to flip Avacyn. Wait a minute. This is really bad.
Oh?
Wait. I forgot that Avacyn was flipping. So if we block the Fumarole with anything, Avacyn flips.
And if we don't block it, we die?
Well, yeah. We have to block it. So, okay. We have to live in a world where Avacyn's flipping. So if Avacyn's flipping, that changes everything. So what we should do instead is... Like, how do you feel about this block? It can't beat anything, but he's nothing. Like, all these guys are dying anyway, so all I'm giving up is the opportunity to sack them to Cletus.
Which you might actually need to do to win?
Well, that's true, but if the original Gear Hulk does die, this does work out. See, if this just goes through, what happens is Avacyn flips, we go to one life, we can't Crypt Breaker, we can't Crypt Breaker anyway. We go to one life, and then we untap, we attack with Cletus up to 4, we draw a kill spell for our turn for the Avacyn, and then we die to the Fumarole.
Well, Fumarole's gonna...
Well, no, he's not gonna swap it if we triple block the Gear Ball. Sorry, this is really complicated. I'm not sure how we win. Thing is, we can't sack guys to Cletus because we have to be able to draw a never return to kill the Avacyn.
We get to attack.
We have one. We might just be locked out.
Okay.
No, if we do the... If we just let him eat our team...
Make this block?
No, make... Just block one thing on the...
Well, the femoral, he'll still flip it. Like, if I just block one thing on the femoral, he like this, he's going to flip it and flip his Archangel, right?
That can go there. Then we can make this a 5-6 on our turn.
Right, so I do this. What happens is this flips. We sack a guy to this, sure. But we've taken 7, so we're at 1. And this is alive. And then we attack our opponent for 5, go up to 6, and then he kills us.
Right. Yeah, okay. Got no choice.
I think the triple block thing is right.
Yep.
It is really bad for us, though, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
Actually, hold on. What if we block with Cleus?
How can that be right?
We'll kill the femoral. We'll gain 3. And if we draw an answer for the Avacyn, we'll actually be okay.
Draw an answer to the Avacyn. We don't have any. We have one answer to the
But
Avacyn.
This also lets us... But we have to draw an answer to the Avacyn. That's the only way we win this game. No line wins if that doesn't happen. Wait, I think this is actually right. This also lets us draw a card because we gain life on his turn, so we aren't just dead if we draw a card.
Should we have 2 shots to find an answer to the Avacyn?
Yes. Which is the only way when we start we want to start with. I think this is actually the right block.
Alright.
It's kind of horrifying. It's like it's like an extremely unlikely to work. Because now we get to draw a card, so we're getting 3. This does put us dead to a kill spell, but we already couldn't possibly do that. Oh no, kill spell. We can't possibly beat that.
Okay, we're dead.
Yeah, that is a factual statement. We drew a land. Such a good draw.
Perfect, perfect.
So now what happens is the Femoral trades for Cleus. We gain 3 to 10. Wait, what?
What happened?
Why didn't Avacyn flip? Avacyn just didn't flip. That was a moto bug.
Avacyn enters the battlefield.
When a non-angel creature you control dies, that was a non-angel creature. Oh, it was exiled by Cleus!
Oh my god, we punted so hard.
Oh, I'm sorry, the whole line we said was wrong. Cleus stops Avacyn flipping. I didn't realize
that. Oh, that's so insane.
Well, that means we're. But that actually means we're still in the game here.
Oh my god, that would have been such a blowout. We could have blown him right out.
I'm sorry, I didn't.
All right,
I didn't realize
well, glad
that.
We made this mistake here on Moto rather than at the GP. That's insane.
Yeah, that is insane. Okay, so now here we are in this spot. I think we want to play either Aether Sphere Harvester because we can block the Avacyn profitably. Like, I want to play Aether Sphere Harvester, Relentless Dead Psycho.
Yeah. All right. I don't think our opponent knew that either.
I don't think he... Based on his... I think his he would have made a different attack if he'd known that.
Well, why are we not leaving a swamp?
Oh, because I'm stupid. I'm sorry. That was obviously right.
Yeah, we're just going to take a damage here.
Well...
Because if we're going to...
Sorry. Yeah, that was bad. Apologize. Although, wait. Yeah, okay.
We played Aether Sphere Harvester. Alright, so, yeah. Block with Relentless Dead, draw a card, buy it back.
Oops, sorry. Sorry, that was just poor.
Yeah.
Man, I'm not playing well this game, I apologize. We're not playing well.
We missed a big thing, but it was kind of a tricky thing, I guess.
Yeah. We got a lot of Cletuses. Should I play a Cletus? I think so. It has lifelink. Stops Avacyn flipping. Does a lot of nice stuff. You okay with that?
Well, we can't. Oh, we can. Still yeah. play the role.
Yeah, we can do it all.
Yeah. Make sure we tap right this time. Though, yeah.
Well, there is no tapping right this time.
Well, we're going to play the Volant instead. So make sure you use Colorless Mana for the clues.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, we still take a damage, ultimately.
No, I see. Okay.
The other problem is that we've no time on the clock because that block was too hard because we got Avacyn was flipping.
Yeah.
Which
we'll see if we can win the game at least. We probably can't win the match, but we can win the game.
Yeah.
Stinks to go so deep in the tank and realize that you messed it up.
Okay, so he just passed his draw card?
Yep.
Okay.
How big is that Colossus?
1, 2, 3. So it's a 5/5.
Okay, let's do that. Then let's eat the Glimmer of Genius.
I'll use one. Yeah, okay. I'm in. I was wondering if we were going to attack with Cletus, but I think it's wrong. Okay.
Wants that Glimmer of Genius.
So next turn, we're going to attack with Cletus.
Yep.
Doesn't have any attacks. Okay, let's draw another card.
Yep.
I'm looking very low, but I think it's still right. We can use Cletus to gain it back.
Yep.
Okay, play this. Oh, I think I want to play this so I can sack to Cletus.
Yep.
Cletus is actually doing pretty good work. I mean, we did draw three of them. But.
Yeah. Well, if we would have played that turn right, I think we would have won.
I think we still are going to win. Yeah. I think we're just winning. Because now that we know Avacyn can't flip, like, if he blocks Tendril Gearhulk, like, it's not like a big threat. If he double blocks, my plan is to sack at least one creature. So here, I assume we want to trade for the Avacyn, sack one creature. I could sack two creatures and trade for the Gearhulk. I think the Avacyn's a bigger threat.
Yeah, let's do that.
I want to sack the Dreadwanderer because it's recursive.
Yep, and tap.
And then I could sack the Relentless Dead and bring it back to my hand. Oh, but actually,
we'll just play another Cletus.
Oh, yeah, there's no reason to sack it. Right. Okay, yeah. Okay. That gets exiled. Play Cletus. Say go. Cletus is seriously impressing me, though.
Yeah.
I now think you're right, and if I play against Blue Red Control or similar deck at the GP, I'll have all three Cletuses in.
Good to know. And we learned that interaction.
Oh yeah, that really weird interaction. The thing is, Avacyn is not a heavily played card right now, so it's just like the sort of thing that doesn't come up that often. Mastering?
Yeah.
I could slam another one.
Yeah.
This. Attack with this menace guy, 6/6.
Yep. It's 5/5. Oh, no, it's 6/6. Yep. Okay. Perfect.
I could alpha?
No, perfect. Just do that. We have minute 50.
Okay. Sorry.
Yep. Perfect attack first. No!
Well, we do actually still win this game because we have Dreadwanderers in the yard. In addition to the History Harvester.
Yeah, but he's at 18 and we have a minute 30 on the clock.
Well, I know. I'll try to play like really fast.
All right. I'll narrate what you're doing. Just do it.
Oh, I can't make a triple wonder because I have two cards.
These are some bad beats.
I agree.
I guess we shouldn't have drawn those cards.
Well, we also could have taken a more conservative line. But anyway, we didn't, whatever. I was trying to play very quickly. Oh my god. Just what we needed, another land. Spell? Okay. That's a spell. Hard counter, I assume, is what's happening here. Okay.
Dread Wanderers come back. Off to the races again.
That was unreal. What happened to us?
We drew like six lands in a row.
Oh god, he's a Gear Hulk. Yeah, we still very easily lose now. See, the thing is, we shouldn't have tapped out, and if we had more time, I think we would have figured it out. Basically, the thing is, we had Kalidus and Relentless Dead.
Yeah.
So, like, leaving up a lot of mana is really effective because you can sack one instead of Kalidus and then, like, bring it back or recur something on his end step. Like, you still could basically two
Nets your board. Yeah, we just shouldn't have played that second Mastery. It didn't make any sense.
Yeah, that was just a bad play. What the heck?
Okay. Well, our opponent drew like five times while we were drawing all those swamps.
Yeah, he did draw a lot of things that weren't swamps. Oh, wow. Shock.
Darn. Dead.
I guess we 3-2'd. I really do think...
I think we could have won that game for sure.
I do as well.
I think we made a mistake.
We made a horrible mistake with the not realizing Avis and Cleek's interaction. And then we made another error by tapping out that one turn.
That one was more of just like a rushing error, though.
Yes.
But I think we would have sniffed out that was not right if we were not just snap doing things. But overall, the zombie deck seems pretty great. I'm really excited to play it in Minneapolis. By the time this goes up, we'll have already played that tournament. So
yeah, I can only assume that we come in first and second in the tournament based on the power level of the deck.
Wouldn't that be grand? That would be the dream.
I mean, we went 3-2 in a league. We probably can't possibly lose at GP, is my assumption.
Would you be beating me in the finals then?
Oh, of course.
Oh, okay, fair enough. I'll take it. If I get second, you can win. Anyway, thanks for tuning in to this standard Mono Black Zombies League. It was a lot of fun to play. I appreciate everybody tuning in to watch. I hope it was interesting and you learned a little bit about the Zombies deck. If you have any questions or concerns or suggestions about the deck, or if you noticed anything interesting in the video and you want to point it out, feel free to drop those comments in the forums below. I check those. I respond to them regularly. So if you leave a comment down there, very good chance that I will be responding to you personally, which is pretty fun. I enjoy doing it. And if you like the video, hit the like button. And if you enjoy the video series, be sure to subscribe to the Channel Fireball YouTube channel. There's tons of videos going up, daily. A lot of great players, LSB. Who else is doing Channel Fireball stuff? It's great. There's a lot of them. LSB, though. He's pretty awesome. So, be sure to subscribe and check out those videos. And thanks for tuning in.